Let me know if we're live, please. Tiny chat. Hit up that hashtag BlastZone to enter for a chance to win a Magic Castle bounce house from BlastZone.com. If you win it, we'll fly out. We'll spend a few hours playing Smash with you in the bounce house.
This is a real thing, by the way.
Yep.
You have the opportunity to be in a bounce house with three grown adults.
So Mel and I spent New Year's Eve at we went to this like fancy schmancy like hotel party resort thing in Cambridge, which is like on the Eastern Shore. And
wait, when did you go? I was just in Cambridge.
Oh yeah, it was this weekend for New Year's Eve.
It was like I was there Sunday.
The Hyatt.
No. Okay. I went down there to bang this girl.
Okay. So our paths did not cross.
Are we live?
Yes, we're live.
That was inappropriate. I'm sorry.
But Cambridge, they do this thing at the resort that's like a... But the reason I bring it up is because, like, the adult thing was, like, they had, like, palm readers, tarot readers, a dueling pianos bar, and then, like, a fantasy casino with fake money. I was like, ugh. And then the kids area was like this giant bounce house that held like 500 kids. I was like, dude, I want to go there. Like,
I would be all about that.
Fuck this adult shit, dude. Like, I'm playing with fake money. I'm playing blackjack and I'm just like hitting on 20 because I'm like, fuck it. I don't care. So, all right, let me tweet this out real quick. Blast live. Come talk smash me. T-Kid Breezy. And... Oh, you got verified. How long have you been verified? It's been a while, right?
No, nigga. It's been 2 days.
Oh, okay. Never mind. I think I got you mixed up with other people.
Alright, let's do this.
Alright, we're live now.
I'm out.
Whew. I'm just letting you know before you give away some VG secrets.
Ah, man. You,
VGB secrets.
You're looking kind of left out right here, man.
Oh, with the CLG, the Twitch, and then...
Yeah, we all see LG out here now. Yeah, was that the gray joint, Phil?
What, the hat?
Was that the black joint? No, the hoodie.
This is a black CLG, a black Twitch hoodie.
You didn't get the Christmas joint?
The Christmas one? Are you talking about the American?
No.
What is that? Oh!
That's nice.
Oh, that's nice. I didn't get that.
That's Twitch?
Yeah.
How does one get one of those?
I don't know, man. They kind of... So one of the Twitch employees hit me up and was like, hey, man, we need your address so we can send you something. For something partner, valued partner, some shit like that. And I was like, word. So then I sent it, and then like 3 months later, it showed up. So I was like, word.
Oh, fuck. I didn't get one of those.
Me
fuck
neither.
That
Twitch. I'm mad as hell.
First of all, I'm definitely more valued than you guys.
Whoa!
Dang, rip.
Whoa! All right. I think we're good. Just gonna wait for people to filter in here. We're getting numbers are slowly going up. So TK's eating anyway. You don't want to eat on stream. Come on. What is up with my chat, dude? I don't know why this isn't working anymore.
I think the first time I actually got really, really upset about someone eating on stream during commentary was definitely Dumbblade.
Really?
I think he was the first person I remember. And he stopped like a long time ago, but I just remember like he was commentating. And then he was like, oh, they just brought my sub. And then I thought he was going to get off.
Oh, I think I remember that.
Yeah, and he just stayed. And I was so fucking pissed, dog. Oh, that was good times.
I think I remember that sentence specifically. Like, oh, they just brought my sub. Alright, let me see. Yeah, chat's not working on the stream for some reason, but I guess it's not a big deal. Just follow the chat down there. Anyway, how's it going, guys? Welcome to Blast Zone. My name is Cody. I'm joined by the Black Plague, Phenomenal EE, and TK Breezy. Hope you guys are having a wonderful new year. Monday, new year, new you, I'm sure. So we're going to be talking about Super Smash Bros. We do this every 2 weeks on Mondays, unless we can. But this week we can, so we're going to be talking about a bunch of different stuff. Also, hit us up. Thank you, TupacLives123. 10 months. Well done. So we're going to be talking about Smash. You guys hit us up using your questions. Hashtag BlastZone. We'll try to get to all of them. Usually it kind of thins out by the end of the night, but we'll have to see. But a lot of stuff to talk about. A lot of things going on in the world of Smash. But first, let me just do my, you know, normal check-in with you guys. How you guys doing? I don't think we've had a show since Zero Saga, have we?
Did we do one
after Zero Saga? I think we did one four, so like right before it, right? Yeah. Okay. Thank you, Gregerson, also.
All together, you know, things have been pretty dope. You know, just been holding it down as the Black Plague, as per usual. Kind of missed you, but we saw everything that happened, so.
Dude, that was legitimately one of the worst nights of my life. Like, that was that was a nightmare. The video of that line was not like it was 2 minutes of me walking, and to get about 15 feet took me 2.5 hours because it takes everybody so long to reschedule. And like, slept in the terminal, didn't get to go anywhere. I think they got a full refund, they being 2GG who was flying me out. But good God, dude, that was the worst experience of my life. And I couldn't get anything out of it. They wouldn't compensate me for, like, my time or anything. So it's just lost weekend, unfortunately. So,
yeah.
But you guys seemed like you had a good time. It was fun to watch. I stream monstered it, so.
Yeah, it was an enjoyable event for sure. I mean, location, the effort that went into the event, of course, and the talent made it all really good, man.
That a good way to actually end. More talent in the convention because at the same time, was this thing called SkillCon that was going on, like, right next to us. There was, like, a lot of jugglers and, like, hula hoopers and dart players and a bunch of shit.
I was wondering what the hell was going on in the background.
Yeah, that was pretty cool on the other side. I really wanted to play that, that soccer dart game that they had because it was, like, you know, kick the ball, Velcro ball, sticks. But every time that I was, like, I was done commentating or something, I usually had somewhere else to be, so I never got a chance to do that. But, yeah. It was a pretty interesting venue, pretty interesting tournament. I don't think there's anything much negative to say about it. I mean, there was a couple commentator choices that were questionable, but it was like full, so who cares?
Yeah.
Other than that, you know, I was chilling.
It's cool. Yeah, it seemed like a great event. Like you were saying, Phil, awesome way to kick off 2016, or not kick off, I guess to end 2016. And we're going right back into 2017 with Genesis 4, and that's a wonderful segue into our first talking point. So Genesis 4 coming up, not this weekend, but the weekend after in San Jose, California. Registration, I'm pretty sure, is closed. They did that thing where like they closed it and then they reopened it, and then it's probably closed again. So if you're not going, you messed up. You should have done it. But it's going to be in San Jose. Last year, Genesis 3 was probably one of the biggest events of the year. Even though it was so early, like that's sticking out in people's heads as, you know, kind of the premier event of 2016, I think. It was a big deal, and I think part of that was because of the production value involved. Like, the top 8 arena was so cool. It was awesome. People loved that. So that's going to be really fun. I had another point, but it kind of slipped out of my brain just now.
Was it Genesis Saga?
No, it was not. It was going to be Numbers Are Down. And I wanted to know if you guys had any idea about that. I think it's just because it's the return of Genesis, like that whole luster is gone, and if they make it like a yearly thing, I wonder if that's going to go down. But do you think that has to do with, like, you know, just so many big tournaments going on at the same time, or just kind of the lack of that, like, surprise factor?
How much are Numbers Down?
Not considerably. I can't remember the exact numbers. I'd have to find it somewhere.
It was a few hundred.
Yeah, but it wasn't crazy. Teams were down a lot, actually. Teams were, I think, down something like 75%.
Oh, that's sad.
Yeah, like sad. That just went.
That's
rock.
A pretty huge drop off. I mean, you know, last Genesis, you know, did have that luster of, okay, this tournament series is coming back that, you know, has some epic matches. You know, Armada Mango, obviously. Like, it did have that luster to it. But now we're kind of in an era where we're seeing all these big tournaments come. So, yeah, it is a little harder to sustain maybe that level of attendance. And also, it's not on a convenient weekend to a lot of people, I've heard, because a lot of people said, like, school is, like, a major deterrent as to why they can't go. So it's not as convenient as it was last year.
Right.
But they're still pulling good numbers, you know what I mean? Obviously, California's not the cheapest place, so that's always a factor, too. But I don't know. It's still one of those tournaments that even if it goes down a little bit, it's not like significant enough where you're gonna see like they're not gonna host it again the following year.
Yeah,
you know what I mean. Like the support is there, so I kind of think that's what I'm thinking.
Yeah, I think it's gonna be a great event. I wonder if, and I kind of want to get into this in a little bit, when we talk about the venue fees, but I wonder if it's just, like, so many big events going on at the same time, like, you can't make it to every single one.
Right.
Kind of going off what you were saying, but 2GG has announced Genesis Saga, and I actually don't know as much about that as you guys, really.
It's just the first...
Like, as part of the circuit, right?
I actually don't even know if that's part of the circuit, is it?
I didn't know. That's what I was going
to
ask you.
It's the opener to the circuit.
Okay.
It's also kind of like a prelude here to Genesis itself as well. So it kind of serves as a two-for-one there. It's a good deal.
Yeah.
And I'm pretty excited about that, you know. We didn't have a Blast Zone when it was announced, like, initially a couple weeks ago.
Yeah.
But I feel like the Smash World was pretty much a buzz about it because it's setting such a huge precedent for our game.
Yeah.
Yeah, but it's like a coin flip right now, at least on the vocal side, because I see a lot of people that are like, yes, 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 but this is the people who understand esports, but then you have these other people who are, oh, 2GG is doing it again, you know, they're cutting in on other people's dates, but,
you have to step on toes to do this shit.
Oh, yeah, at this point in time, I don't even care,
the
dates that you're stepping on are tournaments that people were kind of most likely going to anyway, because there was nothing else going on. Like, me and EE have already talked about some of the tournaments that we decided not to go to in lieu of 2GG, you know? Like, we're already on board to go to 2GG for tournaments that haven't even fucking announced yet. Like, we just know, like, the experience that we had at 2GG was a lot better than what we could be potentially getting into or subjecting ourselves to at other tournaments. So I just,
right.
You know, like, that type of thinking, though, really hurts esports in general, though, because, like, as we're growing... More people are like, man, I really wish we stayed grassroots. But then if we decide to stay grassroots, everyone's like, wow, man, Smash really has no money in it. And I'm like, well, every time we put more money into it, everyone starts to fucking complain. Like, it just doesn't work like that.
We gotta weed out the complainers at this point. I mean, you understand the potential behind this game. If you have a favorite, if you enjoy watching a game, playing a game, then you want to see your favorites succeed and be able to advance themselves through this path that they've chosen right now in their life. You're not going to get that by a bunch of grassroots bullshit. And to 2GG's credit, they announced all the dates in advance. So we have the dates for the year. And I've actually gone through a lot of them. And they don't really overlap with anything. Like, they might be a week before something or a week after something. But it's not overlapping with a CEO Dreamland and Evo, you know, Smash and Splash or whatever. It's you know, they did a good job picking those dates and working with Esports Arena so that, okay, you know, even if it does... conflict with something, it's not the same date, it's just, you know, like a week before, a week after, which is fine.
Yeah.
The hardcore players will attend everything, and then, you know, California just has such a strong and thriving scene regardless, they're always going to get those numbers, so they don't have any problem pulling people. But yeah, I definitely like where we're going in, as far as an official event like this is going.
Yeah.
It's a very good start to where Smash deserves to go.
I think people have been talking about it and, like, hinting at it for so long, and, like, I'm glad that somebody's actually stepping up and doing it. And like you guys said, like, if you have to step on toes to knock out, like, one or two people's events, it sucks, and I get it, but, like, we need this. We've needed this. This is long overdue, and, I mean, 2GG is stepping up to the plate, and they're delivering something that everybody has asked for since the start of Smash 4. It's been 2.5 years. Like, why have we not had this yet? So, I mean, and honestly, I feel like Champ, in his whole team, but Champ in particular, is one of the most trustworthy guys you could hand something like this to. He clearly has so much passion for the scene.
Absolutely. I can co-sign that 100%. I worked with Champ 2 times now, and even, like, at an event that he didn't even host, he's offered to, like, help me out before, too. Like, he's a really good guy. He's really for the scene, and I have no support for anybody who gives him shit. He's fantastic.
Yeah. I was really looking forward to meeting him. And honestly, the rest of the 2GG team, like, I've talked with Bam a few times, but never, like,
he's cool.
To an extensive level. I was supposed to be on the analysis desk with Swar and Strides and some of the other people over there, but that didn't pan out because I couldn't make it. But I feel like that's another thing. And I heard a lot of criticism about it. I haven't had a chance to watch it yet, just because I've been bouncing all around. It's 30 minutes long.
I thought it was good.
Yeah. I've heard that it was a little dry, and to be fair, that's kind of like where I was supposed to be brought in. Like, I was the not numbers guy. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But I mean, at the same time, though, like, there's two different complaints for that, because where I saw the dry, there was also some people that were like, I feel like the analyst desk wasn't analytical enough.
Was
like,
it dry
because
enough?
Because they weren't. No, it wasn't. It wasn't. Yeah, it wasn't dry enough. Like, in the point where it's like, all right, these guys aren't. They're talking numbers like. this guy beat this guy for this time. But they wanted someone to be up there and like talk about like frame data and shit like that. And I'm like, that's not, I don't think that's really what the Annals of Death is. Like that time that you would need for that is not going to fit in the Annals of Death slot.
Either. Right.
So. Yeah.
No, you're right. When we're talking analysis, we're not talking about game by game, like play by play analysis. What we're talking about is player sets, set counts, stage counts, what we're expecting to see out of the two at kind of a macro level. And then if they're utilizing one strategy, we can talk about that, like the fact that Zero's like ledge trapping has become kind of the best in the world, and that's probably why he's so dominant right now. We can talk about that, but like we're not going to break down, like for instance, Void's. We could say that Void is using up air in really creative ways and then kind of talk about a few of them, but we're not going to break down every single use, you know what I mean? We don't have the time for that, but...
Yeah. Like, if you can't blatant statement that, then it probably shouldn't be talked about. But, like, then Fossil was, like, one of the main proponents I saw. I was like, man, I really wish we had someone who just... If you're going to have an analyst that you need to have someone dig deep. And I'm like, Fossil, you... Like, as a person who even works in production, you should understand this doesn't work. Like, that's going to bore the shit out of, like, 90% of the people watching. So, I mean...
Fossil works in production?
Fossil makes videos.
Where's that brawl doc? All
right, well... Next topic.
Lazo.
He's been working on it, man. I see him interviewing people at pretty much every event. So one day.
I'm just teasing.
Yeah. So that's happening, and that's great. That's wonderful. So let's see. Getting on to the next thing. I lost my train of thought because I've been trying to fix this chat thing. There we go. Cool. Okay. So, TGG, Saga, putting out a circuit. It's going to be awesome. Genesis 4 coming up. I feel like our job as a show is, like, talk about our picks for Genesis 4 and, like, talk about who we think is going to win. But, like...
That was never our job. You want that show, go watch Anti.
I guess it's true.
Anti, and Dave said they were going to start doing that shit. Dave has very uninformed opinions, so that's going to be pretty interesting to watch. But yeah, no, our show, bare bones to me has always been, you know, we take the issues of Smash or like the things that are happening, current events of Smash, and we talk about it and bring it to light in place of talking all data, you know. We can talk about why Nairo doesn't place second as much as he used to all day, but that shit is going to get boring after a while.
Yeah, and if we just say Zero is probably going to win, LOL, like that doesn't... Yeah. Doesn't mean anything. Also, just before I forget, thank you, Nearet. Thank you, Papa Slumbo. Thank you, everybody, Gregerson, everybody that subbed while that was happening. I don't have alerts, but thank you, guys. Okay. Yeah, that Day in Anti show would be fun to watch. I want to see that.
I would watch it. Yeah, I mean, even if I don't like agree with Day's fucking like picks or whatever, like he's still funny as shit. So I will definitely watch it, regardless if I liked him, what he said or not.
He had a really good interview with Event Hubs. Did you guys read that?
Yeah, I did.
I liked that. That was really well done. We need more of that, I think. Like, I got into a chat on Twitter with Tafokins, and this is kind of going off the side. And he was saying that the only people that really get views in terms of, like, Smash content, particularly Smash 4 content, too, are, like, superstars. So, like, Zero or some of the gods in Melee. But I feel like if you build up the people lower, it'll take a long time, and maybe there's, like, a nuanced way to go about it, and I could be completely wrong, because obviously he knows what he's doing, and he works in this stuff, but I think there's a way to present situations, like Mr. R, who's always the fucking bridesmaid, Mr. Second Place, and now he sometimes can't get into top 8. We can talk about him, and, like, is he ever gonna win that major? You build that up. Now Day has this, like, reputation as having this, like, crazy fire under his ass, because he plays a... not as strong character, but he has that kind of early mindset that we all have where, like, okay, I'm going to take my character to the extreme, I'm going to beat all these tier horrors, blah, 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 that we kind of got beat out of us. I think there are ways to position guys, and I'm kind of going off on a tangent, but I want to see more stuff like that. I think it just takes a really good writer. So, that's what I think. Alright, so, let me think. So that happened. That was good. Genesis. And... I'm trying to get back my train of thought, because I keep... my brain's all over the place, so... Alright, next thing happening. Panda Global Ranking. Worldwide Ranking.
Global... Yeah, you're right. I was looking at the rest of my calendar, which I definitely need to redo now that
I've... Do you have anything else?
December's over. No, we're just MAGFest, Genesis 4, and PAX South, but PAX South doesn't have Smash this time, so yeah, no, nothing.
Okay.
Anyway.
Oh, by the way, MAGFest. If you guys are going to MAGFest, VG has a panel, 7 p.m. on Friday.
So, 7?
Or I'm sorry, 9.
Yeah, I was like, I've been saying 9, what the fuck?
My bad, no, you're right. 9
it's
p.m.
on Friday?
And it's on Thursday. I'm stupid.
Yeah, it's Thursday. It's definitely Thursday.
I don't know what's going on with me. All right, 9 p.m. Thursday.
I'm the one drinking, and he's the one who loses his memory. That's
I'm fucked up. Dude, I can't, like, if one thing goes wrong ever, like, if I'm playing a game on stream and my frames are, like, one frame below 60, I go fucking, like, my brain goes all over the place, and my chat isn't working on the stream right now, so I'm trying to figure out how to fix it and run all these things at once, so my brain is short-circuiting, because I'm an idiot. So, alright, so anyway, Panda Global Ranking, let's talk about that. Top 100 players in the world, or is it 50? I think it's 100, right? They're doing 100?
Are they doing 100 this time?
I think so. That's what I heard. Unless they're
if they're doing 100,
they don't need to do 100.
I don't think they need to do 100. You're just trying to have more people fight for no reason. maybe 50 and 5 honorable mentions is the most that we need.
Yeah. Yeah, I might be thinking of the Melee and on me, you know, that 100, which is happening right
just
now also.
They're saying it's just 50.
It's just 50? So, yeah. Okay, my mistake. Yes,
confirm.
Yeah, I might be thinking about that thing. Can you imagine the 100? Good lord. That'd be wild. Alright, so Panda Global Rankings, we got the top 50 in the world. I'm looking at the list right now. The bottom 10 last year, a lot of these guys are going to stick around. We got Terror Bear, he's probably going to drop off. Nick Riddle, not sure how he's going to do. Cockagen, like, they'll
those
probably...
Those are all drops. Those
yeah, they're going to be cut, but at
Hold on, man. Cockagen's still winning stuff in his respective region. I don't know how much that's going to weigh in for him.
Well, the problem is, like, local hero, I mean,
points is points, man. If you get first, you get first.
Well, I mean, we'll see. I don't know how they're gonna weigh it. I don't know if he's actually attended any nationals or if he has.
The last time I saw him actually play was PAX Arena. He got, like, third or fourth. But other than that, I haven't seen him do shit. But,
We'll see. I mean, locals do go a long way. Obviously, somebody like Wadi is gonna be on there. Pink Fresh for their strong Xanadu performances. They'll be all right.
You've got a ton of new talent, too. I mean, that's what I think is the most exciting, because, like, I don't know if, like, Salem was on this list before. I don't think Samsora, Captain Zack, people like that.
Those are all people who are going to be on for sure.
Yeah, these guys
are going to make a splash. You got to weed out those players. Yeah,
no, I guess you're right. Yeah, if you put it like that, I forgot all these new players came up this year, so.
And then you've got people in the bottom 10, so like Scat, Ice Studying, Fatality. Fatality's definitely, I think, going to stay on. I don't think there's any question about that. Ice Studying. Yeah, I'm not sure about Ice Studying. Scat, probably going to enjoy a nice little bump, too. So, but really, I don't want to go through every single one. I kind of just wanted to go through the top 10, see what you guys thought. So let's go through and talk about these. So number one, Zero.
And guys, we're reading off from last year's PR. This isn't a leak
of this year, just
so people understand that.
That's a good thing to say, yeah. So we're just talking about last year, and we're kind of discussing what we think people are going to move to or from. If you guys have a question about a specific player, hit us up using hashtag GlassZone. We just don't have time to talk about every single person. We'll be here forever. So Zero, I think he's sitting at first.
Still, yeah.
Yes, obviously.
I don't think that's a question. I think it could
be. If he's... No. If he wasn't first, for only losing, I think, 2 to 3 tournaments, or, like, in this ranking, then I would have not even cared about the rest of that fucking list, to be completely honest. Like,
yeah.
There's no way. There's no absolute way that the one time he finally loses to Leo, or whoever, he finally ends up sinking out of the first spot. Zero's still first by a long shot for, until these results start to look kind of like, I guess, Nairo's are allies, where
right.
He makes first a lot, but he also makes third and fourth a lot, you know?
So. Yeah. Zero had kind of a weak summer, and he did disappear during that whole Bayonetta thing, but I think he's come back so dominant that we can't even question it.
And then the quarter, I think the quarter started at EGLX, by the way. Spoiler.
Okay, yeah. Well, even then, like, I don't know if we can count it, but if you want to talk about that Zero run back thing against everybody that's ever played him, and he won every fucking set... That I don't know if we can count that for results, but Jesus Christ, like.
Yeah, that was
good. Well, I think what that did for Zero was, it showed that no matter what bracket that he got within, like, like 2GG. Like no matter where he placed, like you couldn't say, oh, he only got here because he didn't have to play so and so.
Yeah.
No, he played so and so the day before and he whooped our asses.
Yeah.
So, and he only lost to Leo, who was the first time who defeated him.
Lost to Ally too.
Yeah, yeah, Ally. I mean, he's lost to Ally before. Though,
yeah, that's Ally.
That's a coin flip.
Yep.
Match. Right there.
All
right.
So number two is at least last year. Number two is Nairo. What do you guys think? He's probably gonna fall, right?
Probably, but I mean, if I, he's between two and four.
I agree.
Like,
yep.
Yeah. So even if he falls, like, it won't be like he plummeted. It's literally be between two and four.
It's gonna come down to the results, like whoever's crunching the numbers between, like, because I got Ally at number two, probably.
Yeah, and you know what? That's something I've gone back and forth on, because I originally was thinking Ally at number two, Nairo at number three, but the reason I think Nairo might maintain, if you compare their losses, like Ally's losses are a lot worse than Nairo's. Like he's got some.
Can you
he's
give
got
me some examples?
Losses. That random Corrin player at CEO. He lost to Zenyu and losers in the Ditto, and that's like Zenyu's not a scrub or anything, but like compared to the people Nairo, like look at like at, I know he didn't do that well at Evo, but he lost to Larry and Renaya at Evo. That's who Nairo lost to, right? That's not awful. And Ally had a really good strong start to the quarter, I feel like. He won Smash Clash, get on my level, obviously won Evo. But just some of those losses, man, are just like I don't know about some of that shitty. I studying, he lost to a UGC. That's, I consider that a bad loss for him.
For number two in the world, I mean? Like a prospective number two in the world. Yeah, I could see that. So,
and Nairo, you know, he did good. He won that Vegas thing. He won EGLX. He won Super Smash Con. So I think there's going to go. I think Nairo's been more consistent than Ally for sure, especially as far as like losses go. But, I mean, those two to me are interchangeable at two and three.
Nairo's worst loss is probably the Robin, the Pound, right?
But that doesn't count in this quarter, so it doesn't matter.
Oh, you're right. Okay. Yep. That's true. Yeah, I guess he doesn't really have a bad loss then. Okay. So Nairo, somewhere between 2 and 4. I agree with TK. Thank you, Jiffy Sticks, by the way. 7 months. Woohoo. All right. DaBuzz, number 3. That's a drop. Right?
That's a drop. Not as significant as people might think, but that's definitely a drop.
Yeah. I'm not going to guess where. Probably still in the top 10, but
I'll give him 6 or 7.
Yeah. Mr. R at 4th. Again, I'm going to have to say a drop on that.
Yeah, but only it's not because his skill's dropping. It's because of the he's getting pushed down, put it that way.
Yeah,
he's not dropping. He's getting pushed down.
Yeah. So. He's getting kind of pulled. I feel like the Sheik nerfs and all this other stuff have kind of affected his play, kind of in the long run. We haven't seen him quite as dominant as he used to be. Abadango at 5?
Abadango was 5 last year? Wow.
Yeah, isn't that surprising? I was kind of surprised by that.
I think he'll get pushed down a little bit. I think he'll still be in the top 10.
Yeah.
But I'm looking more at 8 to 9, maybe 7.
Okay. Yeah. Ally at 6, we already discussed this. I see him anywhere 2, 3, 4, somewhere around there, along with Nairo. Larry at 7, I feel like he's going to be the guy to bump down to Buzz. So Larry's probably going to move up to 5 or 6, I think. If I had to guess, I'd put him up there.
I could see that. I mean, man's worst placing, I feel like, is at Big House.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, Larry's been doing awesome lately. Definitely has been doing much better as of late, kind of blown up. Void right behind him at 8. Probably gonna. I feel like he's gonna stay like.
I feel like he's gonna move up, but like only by like 1. Like I hard think Void's gonna get 7th.
Mm-hmm.
Like if you were like what's top 10, I'd be like Void's at 7th. Like,
yep.
Like I wouldn't even say anything else about anyone else. Like,
that's a good pick. And honestly, I feel like Void and Larry are always gonna be like. At least for now, I can't think of them without thinking of them, like, you know, right next to each other. Like,
yeah.
I that's just how I'm considering them. And then maybe it's because they're so close in sets, so I shouldn't be thinking of the head-to-head, but there's that. Renai at 9, he's gone. Maybe, I don't know how he's doing in Japan. I know that he's, like, not playing as much, so probably top 20, maybe top 30. Definitely.
Renai will be on the list, but yeah, he did well at Evo though. That's the thing. Like he got top 5 at Evo. That's hard to ignore. So he's still gonna be in that top 15 area.
Yeah. And then number 10 is Anti.
Okay.
So Anti,
I mean, God, like, see, that's the that's difficult because
yeah,
Anti's won shit and he's got second and he's got third, but he's also got like 17th.
Yeah.
So like, I'm Anti's like, man, I wanna believe that I want Anti to move up. You know, personally, he's one of my favorite players, and I believe that if he does move up, it won't be super far up. Like, he won't go from like 10 to 5, but I can see him go to 10 to like 8, 9. Can't give him 7th. Mm-hmm. Yeah, maybe 6, but can't give him 7th. You know,
I think the main thing on that list that we're going to see is we're taking Renai out and we're putting Leo in. Leo's going to be top 10.
That's my next question.
That's not even a debate. I mean,
yeah.
People are delusional if they think otherwise. I think Anti and Mr. R are going to, Anti and Mr. R are probably going to be like 9 and 10, like around there.
Okay.
They're gonna be the ones like knocking on the door at the top 10 or whatever.
I agree.
Or holding it, I should say. And then you're gonna have, I think Leo has to be below. He has to be below Larry and Void for my money. So I got Leo in there somewhere at 7th or 8th. I feel like, but no higher than that.
I'm seeing a bunch of people saying Leo at like 2nd or 3rd, and I'm like, Jesus, no, stop.
It's based on stuff that we have in this quarter, and he hasn't been able to attend all that stuff. Luckily, we'll have a more solid rating for him the next PGR for good reason. He'll be here a lot more and stuff. But definitely, I got Mr. R at 10th, and then probably, I mean, maybe Anti Leo. That is hard, right?
That is hard
because
Leo kind of shook CEO up. He shook it up basically. Yeah. Like Leo and a lot of these Japanese players who started coming over to America more often really shook up the PGR, because before they weren't even a factor. It was like, all right, the PGR is American circuit ranking, and next thing you know, you have Abadango. You know, you have Renai. Well, Renai is gonna fall off, but Leo coming through, and all the other Japanese players coming through in placing in the top 8 almost every time. So it's like, all right, well now we have to include them, but also because they beat people who are Americans and push them in spots farther down than they usually are. Like, you know, say Anti could have got 4th somewhere, but then he had to play Abadango and he ended up getting 7th instead. You know, all that stuff factors into this PGR thing, so it's kind of hard to just.
Yeah.
Now, I think that's, I got to give kudos to the PGR people for working on this, knowing damn well that there's going to be backlash regardless of what they put out.
Oh, hell yeah.
But, can't please everybody. It's hard.
Yeah, you can't please everybody.
I think it's going to come down to whoever's, like I said, crunching the numbers, looking at the placements. It is going to be subjective, but like, we can't remember every single placement that these guys had, every single win and loss. So whoever's, you know, kind of burning the books on that is going to have to inform us. I'm trying to think of all the people that have won a major in 2016. And by like all the people, I mean all the people realistically like top 10. So like Pigfresh won KTAR Saga. Don't see him being top 10 by any stretch of the imagination, but like, so I could just think of Zero, obviously, Ally, Anti, Larry.
I think you need to fix your mic or something.
Oh, is my mic doing it again? Oh!
Turn it up.
This happens sometimes. Okay, I don't know why it does that. So I'm trying to think. I'll just repeat myself. I'm trying to think of the top 10 players that have won a major. Like, I'm not counting Pinkfresh, who won KTAR Saga, because he's not going to be top 10 by any stretch. But I can think of Anti, Ally, Zero, Larry,
Nairo.
Is it just those 5?
Out of those, let's see, Larry, you said Larry, right?
I said Larry, yeah.
So we got Void hasn't won, like, the big one yet, nor has Abadango.
Yeah.
Void finally broke that curse, though.
That's true?
Yeah, he's been the fourth place master for, he was the loser semis master.
I was proud of Void at Zero Saga because he got so much shit for being seeded third. And what did he place? Third.
Yeah.
Lived up to that seed.
And he was the only person to beat Leo. So.
Yeah, he went 1-for-1 with Leo, too. Very, very impressive.
Yeah. Mr. R hasn't won one, obviously. I mean, like, when you're looking at strictly who won the big one, there's a very small list. And you got to wonder if that's going to bump people up more. And like we kind of just talked about Anti, like, he's won a huge event. But at the same time, he's been kind of inconsistent. He's gotten 17th sometimes, has some pretty, you know, eyebrow-raising losses like Xaltis. Just a lot of surprises all around, so we'll see. All right, so that's the PGR stuff. And then just to wrap up, like, let's talk about, like, the five that might be just right on the cusp. So you said that Mr. R and Anti would kind of be knocking on the 10th. I think they're
9th and 10th.
Yeah. I think they're both in there. But let's talk about, like, 11 through 15. Right. So players like Mars, maybe Mr. E, if you guys think he might be on there.
Mr. E might be. Like, if Mr. E's on there, he's literally, like, at 15.
Yeah,
like,
I agree.
There's no way Mr. E is going to be higher than 15. I agree with that. 14. I say 14. Then. 14.
Yeah. I mean, you're definitely going to see Renai in there.
Okay.
Como as well. Definitely Como.
Yep. Him. Kameme, you think?
I don't know. Dude.
Yeah, me neither.
I think so because second at Evo is really good, but you know he hasn't done anything else. I hate to be that guy, but Big House didn't top 8 it. UGC didn't top 8 it. Your Zero Saga didn't top 8 it. I mean, if I mean in Japan, I know he does well too, but if I'm looking at those big American events, I'm not seeing it. You know what I mean? I'm not seeing it. But can I definitively say like whoever else we're gonna name would be better than Kameme? No, I can't. I can definitely say you know Renai and Koma will be there. Kameme probably get there. Obviously Salem will be in there, but I don't know. That's a tricky one for me, man.
It's a noodle scratcher.
Salem, Como, and Renai definitely in the top 15.
Yeah, definitely. Okay. And kind of just to wrap up, so TK, you said that you wanted to talk about this more. Before we get into questions, hit us up, #BlazeZone, answer any question. You guys wanted to talk about the commentary thing that just came up, the 2GG put it out there for casters and stuff. Did you have any thoughts on that?
Yeah, I'm actually, like, really upset in the way that it has taken this long for all these good things to happen when we've had these resources for so long. Like, no one wanted to put anything into motion until 2GG came around. Now we have a circuit, and now they're actually, you know, asking the real hard-hitting questions about what can be done to make tournament experience better for people working for it and tournament experience better for people who are watching. And I'm like, all right, so we've technically been getting paid for commentary for like 2 years. You know, the first year sucked. The second year kind of sucked. And now we're going into the third year. I feel like the second year could have been the year that everyone started to give a shit, because that was the year that everyone really started to pick favorites, you know? Like, that was the year when commentary started to come under fire. You know, you couldn't be a bad commentator anymore. Like, if you're bad, people told you, and you were exiled, basically.
Yeah.
So you get to this point where now you're asking the audience what do they want to hear and who do they want to see, and then the audience is like, okay, just for lack of a better team, we want to see the Black Plague. All right, cool. So they hit us up and we're like, word, we're down to come to your tournament. All right, see you there. That's not how it works, okay? That's not how it works. You're trying to hire us right now. That does not mean I'm going to put my money to work for your event when you know damn well the reason why your event is even successful and the point for top eights is because of us. You know, like, you have players, of course, but if you put local commentators on a national top 8, it's going to get shot on.
Yep.
So when we started getting lowballed, first I lowballed myself because I'm like, all right, man, Smashers broke, whatever. I don't pay enough attention to where the money goes, right? Like, I don't know how the venue, like, splits down, who gets paid off of this stuff. So whenever someone was like, oh, we can only pay you like 200, whatever, I'd be like, oh, okay, you know, that sounds reasonable. And so one day, I went to Combo Breaker 2015. Yeah, 2015. And I wasn't even on, like, the payroll for that. And Rick just walked up to me at the end, and he was like, I never let anyone go unpaid, and I can't pay you a lot, but I can pay you $300. So this guy, who did nothing for me, you know, does know nothing about me, but knows that I worked and did top 8, just paid me $300. Wow. I had to struggle to get $300 out of people who I've been working with for years, right? Mm-hmm. So now 2GG's coming out with the woodworks, and we're like, all right, what do you want? Realistically, what I want, I don't even know if I can get. But I see other people saying that, and I don't think they deserve it. Like, people are saying the things that I feel like I would want, and I don't even ask for that much. All I've really asked for so far was flight, hotel, and, like, $500. Like, that was my going rate all of last year, and I barely fucking made that.
And this is while you're doing top 8s.
While I'm doing top 8s.
Yeah.
Yeah, while I'm doing top 8s. I mean, I've done almost every top 8.
And not just
since
top
game
eight.
Came out. Not just top eight. Yeah. It's not like I just walk up in there and you know I do top 8. I do pools. I do top 64.
Doubles.
I did.
Yeah.
I do doubles. I did, actually, in Cobble Breaker, I did top 16 to the finish of the tournament. So I did top 16 with DC, and then I did top 8 with DC with D1. And, like, that was back-to-back. You know what I mean? I was, like, 5-6 hours of commentary straight up. I don't know. But, I didn't catch any fatigue, and I liked the job. But, all I've ever asked for was Flight Hotel 500. And that seems like a very basic price in comparison to what I see other people getting paid. Say it, like, the higher commentators than me, the Melee commentators, Street Fighter commentators, fucking Overwatch, they're getting, like, thousands, you know?
Yeah.
We're trying to, like, we're lowballing ourselves over here, but we're still asking for more than, I guess, every other commentator. So I would put that out there, and then someone would come back and be like, oh, that's a little steep. And I'm like, is it, though? Like, is it actually? Like, I don't feel like that's steep. I feel like with me saying Flight Hotel 500, I'm actually spending at least $200 right there at the tournament, you know what I mean, for eating and all that other good shit. So realistically, I'm getting Flight Hotel and $300 plus $200 reimbursed back to me, and however long they fucking take, because I mean, to be completely honest with you guys, we still haven't been paid for Canada Cup, and that shit was in October. So with 2GG putting out this this information, what do they want? I'm gonna tell them what I want, like what I see our vision for now. Like, you have Black Plague, clearly the most requested duo for Smash 4. I mean, people are requesting this for Melee. Like, we're not gonna do it because obviously, like, that's set in stone.
Yep.
But people definitely ask us all the time, like, are we ever gonna get back to Melee? And I just say no. But like, will you have us on this world renowned circuit that you're trying to have? I'm asking for Flight, I'm asking for a hotel, and I'm asking for $500 per day, straight up. And you can work me as much as you want in that day. In all three of those days, I can do the entire tournament for $1,500 if you need to do that. But I'm asking for $500 per day, and if I don't get it, most likely I'm not going to that tournament. And once people start getting, you know, these low-balled commentators out there, and I'm just sitting in the chat chilling, and people are starting to complain about the commentators that are there instead of us not being there, then I'm like, hey, they should have paid us. Because at this point in time, man, we've lost a lot of money last year. A lot of the times that I spent doing these free tournaments or these very low-ball tournaments, such as Evo, who didn't pay for shit, and we had to pay for all our stuff, and then I end up not even making the amount of money that I spent to get there. I could probably just make money on my own stream. Like, that is my other job. I do stream a lot, and I would rather just not have to deal with getting lowballed or getting, like, underappreciated when I can just be appreciated on my own fucking stream.
Yeah.
That's why sure. I'm really happy that 2GG has opened up the conversation. I saw some really good responses, from them. Most people who don't commentate have just kind of said, well, free venue.
They don't get it. They don't get it.
But for the people who do commentate, they definitely understand, you know, you need this. Because most commentators don't have the money to get out there to every tournament that you want them to come out to. So
I think we're pretty clearly at the point, if nothing else last year, I think was kind of it was foundation. It's, it kind of created this, I think it's now kind of set in stone where our commentators lie. I think it's very clear that you have tier 1 commentators who are doing most top 8s, and I think that exists with, like, U2, D1 probably. And then you have tier 2 commentators who do top 16s, tier 3 that do top 32, and so on and so forth. But I feel like there are some issues with that, obviously, because it kind of presents a scenario where it doesn't look like there's a lot of vertical movement. Like, maybe somebody is a tier 3, but people think they should be a tier 2. Like, I don't know when that distinction is made, but I think it's clear now that there's a understanding of where certain commentators are in the lay of the land, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And I feel like that is what we need to set our... If we're going to ask for some kind of compensation, I feel like that needs to be the... Like the same way that you define it, seed 1, seed 2, seed 3, and pools, you do the same shit for commentators, and you pay them accordingly. The people that do your top 8 should be making more than the people doing pools. Clearly, obviously.
Yeah, I agree.
Doubles should probably be less if you're doing, like, top 8 of doubles, because that gets less views, and that's fine. Doubles is a passion project for a lot of people, but, it's... I think that's where the conversation needs to start. And, like, people in the chat are talking about the commentator tier list. I think everybody shits on that because, like, that's so subjective. And, like, commentary can have so many styles and different, ways to work.
Yeah, commentary, it's flavor, man.
But the best thing is, like, the best commentators switch flavors. I think that's what it is. It's, like, the best commentators gel with each other and they have, like, they can provide complementary styles to other people until we get like pure static teams, kind of like what you guys are doing. I think that that's going to be the most value for a commentator, somebody that can go with anybody.
I've always wanted the static team. I've tried to do that with you too, but you know, you got.
I was like, busy. Yeah.
Yeah, but like it's just like I've always wanted stat teams because that's always how I felt. Just like I feel like teams will be a very more like revered aspect of Smash 4 if more people did static. Like, you know, that's why I was at Zero Saga, was it Zero Saga, where I was making all those team names. I was trying to push that narrative of get these people to team, you know, TMCLG, Team International, all that good shit. To make it easier, one, for people to follow who's on what team, and also two, just to push a narrative of having like actual fucking teams instead of just top player with top player because I didn't have anyone else to play with.
Yeah,
but yeah.
Esam said, "Bring DM Brandon back. If DM Brandon comes back, I call him. Like we, he's
that
my
don't wanna co- he's don't my static come partner.
I know.
DM is
there's no money
DM
in
is
it.
Far above Smash, but I like how he's still." Active enough to tell us, you know, what he thinks we should get and stuff like that. And I value his tips and opinions as well. Like, you know, I mean, he's been at the top. He is at the top. He knows what the hell he's talking about. So it's not like just some rando.
Yeah, exactly.
Nonsense. And about the, I just wanted to kind of jump back to a point about the whole compensation for commentators. One thing you guys should keep in mind is, like, we're very, like, negotiable too, right?
Oh, yeah.
We understand not every tournament has the budget to do, like, flight, hotel, 500 or whatever. But when somebody says, hey, you, like, to me, this happened. They were like, hey, you want to come to my tournament? I'm like, yeah, sure. He's like, well, I don't know if we could afford you. I'm like, well, I don't think I'm an expensive person. I'm willing to negotiate. I'm here for the community. I like to come to events, have a good time, and provide good commentary. And they're like, well, we can get you, and they can give you, you can sleep on, you can sleep in a room with two other people, me and my girlfriend, you know, we'll give you a pillow for a floor space. I don't know about feeding you. But down the road, maybe we can get you reimbursed for some of your travel expenses. I was just like, you know what? I'll get back to you on that.
Let me check my schedule.
You got to come at least with a decent counter offer. These niggas be like, well, we can't do a single thing on your list, but come on anyway, man. We're friends, right? No. Not one hour. We are friends. We can be friends, but I can be friends from my house.
So. I can watch your stream. Like, I can watch. Man. I'll give you that view.
Yeah, that was a rough one, man. I was like, dang, man. Now, this one was not up for discussion. About Triple. we were out of there. So yeah,
we've been kind of doing the whole book both of us thing as of late. And so, like, he handles some of the tournaments because he has better ties with some people, and I handle some of the other tournaments that better ties with other people. But if I don't like the deal, then I send EE the email so I can be like, this is why I don't like the deal, and then we were like, all right, we're not going. So, you know what I mean? Like, if you're not about it, then you just not. If you can't shout out at the very least $1,000 for the top commentators of Smash 4, then I. But you can fly out. But you can fly out everyone from Japan, and you know whatever.
I agree, and I feel like it's. People say that the risk is that you have an issue of like, okay, well they'll just hire lesser commentators and just bring them out for cheaper, and most people still watch. They'll watch now. But if we're talking investment in the future, if you don't have the best commentators on and that top eight, you know, doesn't have the amount of hype and kind of all the stuff around it. I mean, because we're not just talking the stream, right? Because we're talking YouTube. We're talking these, like, incredible moments that happen in top eights. You need seasoned people to talk about that, because if you don't and it's just some fucking Joe talking about, I should say Jim, I guess, if we're talking Smash. If it's just some fucking Jim talking about the game, and something cool I don't know. Something cool. That's the corniest fucking thing, by the way. Jim, I don't. Anyway.
Oh, yeah, I'm pretty much done with
it. I don't like Jim. But let's say that, you know, just some fucking guy talking about the game, like, he's not going to build it up. He's not going to know how to build it to that level. People aren't going to be drawn to the video as much. Like, imagine if just some guy was commentating, like, the Wombo Combo video. Like, nothing would happen. Yeah, that would be lost forever. And you need that stuff, and you need good people. Doing that, and that's going to make your tournament series blow up. That gets eyes on it. So, that's what happens. I think the big fear is when you're talking about, like, okay, so they can't get Black Plague, but maybe they can get, like, two tier 2 commentators. You know what I mean? for cheaper.
Which I guess I'd be okay with, but, you know, once you can't get the Black Plague, but you also don't try to go for, I don't know, say, like, Gunblade and Koopa, you know, like, these two guys, obviously not on the same level as us, but have been notable in commentary.
Sure.
So, like, when you go from there to, all right, well, we're just not going to hire anyone, and we'll, you know, whoever wants to commentate. Of course you're going to get those guys who are like, yeah, I'm raring to fucking go, because they think this is their big break, but really what's happening is you're putting these guys in adversity. Like, people want something, you deliver something totally off base of that, and they're just going to shit on that person.
Can I just jump in real quick? I just want to address something Diamond Donovan said in the chat. He said, who says less commentators can't do that? You guys were inexperienced when you started. Yes, we're referring to, like, larger scale events, like premier events. Like, I'll give you a perfect example of What the Fox 2, right? That had a really nice assortment of talent in that top eight. But the guys commentating it weren't at that level to really commentate, right? There's a lot of complaints in the chat. Reddit even made threads. Like, it was really bad. And one of the guys on there was actually Austie, right? And, you know, since then, I thought Austie had some really good potential. So I've actually kind of worked with him, and I've been helping him trying to get gigs and stuff. So I think he's improved a lot as a commentator, but it's just an example of what we're saying by, like, somebody who's not experienced enough, like, to do this is they're doing it. Like, the guy who commentated with Max, right? And what was it, Get On My Level? Love Rajan. He's a homie. Love that guy. But he shouldn't have been on that top eight. He wasn't ready for that shit. You know what I mean? And the comments and stuff, it kind of showed. You know what I mean? So that's kind of what we're talking about. Like, build yourself up to get to that point, not just hoist it in there because there's nobody else. You know what I mean? That's all I'm saying.
Kind of the piggyback off that.
I'm not trying to shit on anybody. Austie's come a long way. I love the guy.
Yeah. Kind of the piggyback off that. I mean, we were talking about Max at the Beast event that iStudying had that really cool run at. ESAM did really well. Like, Max did very well. They were doing top eight, but the other guy, I don't remember his name, just Meme City, dude. Just constant memes. Hard. And, like, that was just, that killed it for a lot of people. And, like, those videos are probably going to get a lot less views. And, like, I think Beast kind of hurt themselves with that. So that's a thing. So, anyway. Kind of just to get off before we get on to some, into viewer questions. Just 2GG's talking about it, we're talking about it. Commentators should be compensated for a certain amount of, I think, a standardized pay. So that should be coming soon. So your favorite commentators should be getting the level of support, you know, that they should. So that's good. All right. Let us go to viewer questions right over here. Hit us up using hashtag Blessed and we'll answer any question. Please make it Smash related. That's kind of...
We'll still answer it if it's a good not-Smash here question.
Oh, also, I think this voting thing is going on right now. So BAM is happening in May 2018. I'm going to throw this out there. They're flying out two players and one commentator. All three of us are on that list. Gunblade, DC, D1.
Wait, it's only one commentator?
They're flying out one commentator. Now...
Well, congratulations, D1. You got it.
Here's the thing. I know that I have no shot, but Australia is my most wanted place to go ever.
Yeah?
Like, so, just, please. All vote right. for who you want to vote for, but, like, please, for the love
well,
of
God. Well, I'm gonna...
Man, if I get it, I'll throw it to you, straight up.
Yeah, seriously,
I'll throw it to you. I didn't know it was going to flying out one. I thought they were flying out
Yeah, you got
two.
It. We want Coney to go.
No. Don't do that. Here's the thing. The votes are working. They go 1-6. And number one is their most wanted person, and number six is their least. And I am on a lot of 5 and 6, and that's fine. But that's my point, is that, like, I don't want to go if I'm on a live... Like, 5 and 6 is always me and Gunblade. It's really funny. But D1 is, like, everybody's one. EE is a lot of people's one. TK is a lot of people's one. I'm a few people's one, and that's fine. But I'm saying, like, you guys should go vote. That's what I'm saying. It's a Smash Bros.
I'm going to MomoCon, so you got it.
This is in May of, like, 2018, dude.
This is 2017.
No, this is 2018, man.
Why are they playing so far? All right, you know what? All right.
I think it's
Man, you can't plan that fucking far ahead. I might die by then. or forget one or the other. I'm like, yo, you on that plane yet? Like, what fucking plane?
Oh, you know what? You know what, Coney? The reason you think that it's 2018 is because he sent the same message to everybody, and I was like, are you sure you don't mean 2017? And he corrected and said, oh, damn, I'm stupid. I mean 2017.
Oh, okay. So, yeah, I saw 2018 here.
So yeah, it's 2017. Gotcha.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm doing MomoCon or something. I think TK will probably do Combo Breaker. Okay. Take it, man.
We'll see. Okay. Anyway, I just wanted to throw that out there. Okay, so let's talk. Scruffle, first question. Scruffle said least favorite commentator slash type of commentary. Now, come on, man. Least favorite commentator? Like, it's a blasphemy, but we're not doing that. Unless no, you want to do it.
I mean,
you want to throw somebody out? Throw out a name. It's Blast Zone.
Right. So, this is my least favorite commentator. So, I don't like to do least favorite commentator of all time. My least favorite commentator in recent memory was the guy who commentated with Miho. I don't remember his name. But he was really bad. I don't think they prepared him well enough. He's probably like some local commentator and does decent for a local, but these weren't locals. Like, we're now at 2GG Zero Saga. Like, you can't be out here just fucking around. And he was on the mainstream. Not even on the secondary stream, he was on the mainstream. Mm. So that kind of rubbed me the wrong way. And then there was another guy, Two Scoop Pike.
You don't like my homie Pike?
I didn't dislike him, but he was forcing... I watched 3 matches of him commentating, and he was forcing one joke from match 1 into match 3 still. And I was like... So he asked me later. You know, he just straight up asked me later, like, what do you think about commentary? I was like, my nigga, you need to stop forcing shit, because, like, that joke wasn't funny when you first told it, and then it just kept coming up, so then I was getting progressively more upset that you really thought that I was going to be like, yo, this joke is fire. Like, it just never happened. it just never happened.
Yeah.
So, yeah, no, that, other than that, I don't really have any commentators I fully hate. I think I have things that I hate about some of the commentators who I think if they stopped it, they'd be better. Yeah. I have things I don't like that I do. I think I stutter too much, especially in the moment. But that's just brain rewiring. You know what I mean? I can't really fix that unless I decide to speak slower, but then this is not me anymore.
Yeah.
Gunblade got a first? That's crazy. Anyway.
I don't even know if we're allowed to vote in there because I just realized it's an Australia thing, but you guys can go check that out.
Oh, I'm not, but I mean, I'm just looking.
You're just checking it out. Yeah, me too.
Yes. I mean, I definitely got a lot of firsts. Easy got a lot of firsts. D1's got a lot of firsts. But I'm getting surprised when you got a couple firsts too. But I just saw a Gunblade first.
I have a few, but I'm mostly. I'm mostly five or six.
As far as least commentary or my least favorite style is over analytical when it's not called for. Mm-hmm. You can't build a hype moment with man. The frame data shit or whatever. Like, you gotta know when to put that shit out there. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You gotta blend that shit right. I don't really have a least favorite commentator. I mean, if somebody's not that great, then I'm not the kind of guy who's just gonna like try and shit on them.
Because
some
like
people think I'm not that great, you know. But I feel like
it's
I'm pretty fucking good.
I feel like Smash World doesn't have that good pacing to do that. To be able to like Melee or like Brawl, you could do that because that game like a lot of the top level, it got a little slow. You know, it was a lot of camping, a lot of Meta Knights just kind of throwing out tornadoes up air, so you had time to talk about frame data shit, but I feel like things are always happening in Smash 4 where the time that I'm spending talking about why this move hit because it came out on frame 7 or whatever, but it lasts for 3 frames and all that good stuff, someone could die in that time.
Yeah.
Like, you know what I mean? Like, and like, someone could actually die in that time, so I've always been like, I'm not really a fan of like dropping just new, like, just crazy amounts of knowledge. When I know I could. Like, if it really came down to it, I know enough about this game where I could drop almost Pierce-level knowledge. I would never be able to drop Pierce-level because that man just, I feel like he just sits and studies. Like, I don't even think he plays. I think he just opens up a book of just frame data and just reads. But, like, if it came down to it, if I really needed to be super analytical, then catch me in a pools match. Because, I mean, if you ever watch me during pools, I definitely drop hella knowledge.
There's more time, but, yeah.
Yeah.
Kind of piggyback of what EE said, I feel like at a certain level of commentary, what you're really getting is the flavor. I think at a certain level, like, the commentators all are very good at what they do. And kind of, we made this kind of analogy on Twitter, but it's like, okay, once you get to the top level of commentary, really, you're just providing the top level of whatever you're doing. If it's analysis, play-by-play, hype, whatever it is, and you are the best version of that. So, like, instead of, like, vanilla, you're, like, French vanilla. You're this fancy vanilla. You're something plus one, right? You're not just regular chips. You're barbecue. You're, you know, sour cream and onion. You're some fancy shit. And I think that is kind of where commentary goes. And then you put two people together that know what they're doing and know how to compliment each other. And we've talked about this on the show before. Like, there are some commentators that are excellent at doing one thing that they do better than anybody else. And that's why you pick somebody.
Yeah, you gotta be versatile, man. You gotta be able to hang with everybody. That's the biggest thing to me, and I feel like I'm really good at that.
Yeah.
Like, we all are really good at that, in fact.
Yeah.
So.
And
again, not an issue of cockiness. We're just confident in our abilities, and there's nothing wrong with
it. Yeah, right. I've been doing this for so long, it'd be stupid for me not to feel
be
like
confident.
I'm
yeah,
somewhere.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know what I mean? Like,
why would you keep doing it if you, like, yeah.
Well, not even that. It'd just be stupid for me to talk down to myself, because, like, why? You know what I mean? Like, that thin line between confidence and cockiness is always thrown about from people who aren't experiencing the same thing as you, or literally just hating on you for being where you are.
Yeah.
So, you know, because, like, in 2015, I never said anything of, like, I never tried to feel like I was, entitled to anything. But, like, 2017, dog, and I've been doing this top-level commentary for a long time, you know, so at some point in time, I got to get some type of reward.
I think for Smash 4, like, while it was developing, everybody was kind of humble. And, mm-hmm. you know, the game's developing. We'll see how it shakes out. Now it's kind of shaken out. Like, we know who's good. So I feel like we're at that level. In terms of least favorite commentary style, I don't really have one. But I do have, like, habits that I hate. And one of them is just, just that when something cool is happening. Number two, and I see all commentators do this, and I don't know why, but, like, somebody does something cool. And I said this on Twitter, but, like, Nairu does a really cool frame trap, and instead of saying, like, Nairu does a frame trap and takes the game, blah, 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 talks about it, they just go, Nairu! What? Ally does an up smash. Ally! The fuck? Like, what are you doing? And I get the idea, like, I get what you're doing, but, like, that's a pet peeve of mine. That's just something I hate.
Wait, so you probably hated that clip of, Mars started that combo of Pink Fresh, and D1 was just, Mars! Mars!
No, that's okay. If you say it over and over, I feel like that's funny, because that's something different, but if you just do it to end a game, and Ella! But if somebody says it over and over, like, as a combo's happening, I feel like that's okay. That's not the same.
It was so funny, though, because the combo didn't finish like he wanted to. He was like, Mars! 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 Oh, okay. Yeah.
That was good. Oh,
we don't do that shit all the time. You're lying. What we do is we'll say the name, but we'll also say everything that they did.
That's what I'm saying. I mean,
put some detail on that shit.
Yeah,
get the fuck out.
Watch your mouth, dog. Watch your mouth. I'm biased.
You're wrong. You're wrong.
I've heard a lot of people. Oh, and also anime references. Cut that shit out. That is corny. That is 2013. Shut the fuck up. This is just like Dragon Ball Z. Stop. If I have to hear how a match is just like Goku and Vegeta against fucking Cell, shut the fuck up. Stop. Anyway.
Dang, you slammed Koopa's career.
I don't know, man. I've had enough of the anime stuff. I've had enough. That's enough. Also, we talk about this in the Discord all the time, but now I'm just bringing it to light. Saying that the beard gives him his power, like, come on. Like, somebody can't have a beard without somebody talking about it. Like, leave the hack shit, man. Like, come on. Anyway, next question. We spent a long time on that question. All right, what's next?
That's funny.
All right. Sam McClure, how do you think the Melee tier list would change if it had Smash 4 ledge mechanics?
I mean, I don't.
That is a complex question. Yeah. Holy shit.
You'd have a lot of angry Melee players.
Yeah, Sam, I'm not answering that one, dude.
Yeah, I'm not gonna answer.
That's too crazy.
I like the idea of what do you think Melee's chills would be like without L canceling, and wave dashing. I thought about that, but I feel like it wouldn't change too much. I feel like maybe Donkey Kong would go up, but like. I feel like Ganon would still be the worst character. He would immediately become the worst character in the game because Ganon's only a bit of the so.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Alright, Septilogy. Did you know that Link's dash attack is more base knockback and knockback growth than Zard's Flare Blitz? Really?
I did not, but I can see it. I mean, the thing is, you don't see that many Links, so.
No way. We
don't see any Charizards, but you're definitely starting to see more Charizards now because anti.
Oh, yeah. No way that Link's dash attack is stronger. Thank you for the SEP stats.
Base knockback?
More base knockback and knockback growth. It's stronger at all levels than Flare Blitz. There's no fucking way. You're lying. Alright, Darius Faison. Darius Faison. With 2GGC being streamed by 2GG and other big tourneys being streamed by their streamers, what do you think is the future for VGBC? That is a very good question.
We're working on it, man.
Damn it.
I guess we can't really say a lot on here, but it's,
We can't say a lot because we don't know shit. Even if I had information, I don't have information. Like, if I had information to hide, I would still hide it, but I don't have information to hide. That's the problem. I don't know what shit was fucking going on. And I work for them. Shit sucks.
I know some stuff. If you were in the Discord, I was talking with Matt. But
that's crazy how you know more than me. Like,
I was just talking with Matt. Matt and I were talking on Discord. That's it.
Cool, man.
Opossum, by the way. Opossum. Pepis, DTR-based. What was your favorite set of Zero Saga? Also, is Day's Shit Talk as good as people say?
Day's Shit Talk is within the top 10 percentile of Smash 4 Shit Talk because everyone's too fucking nice.
Yeah.
But
it's like Smash inflation. It's like
if you were comparing Shit Talk to like FGC Shit Talk, it's definitely low tier.
Yeah. Favorite set of Zero Saga. Do you guys have one?
Oh, Void Leo the first time.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Mr. E versus Zero in his like run back thing.
Yeah,
that one too.
That was a really good set.
Yeah,
I feel like Mr. E and Zero are just money when they play each other.
Yeah.
But I'd have to agree with Void versus Leo mainly because not only was it the first encounter, like nobody had Void getting the win. Like nobody had Void getting the win.
Yeah.
And they just see this big pop off, which is you don't often see from Void. Void has a lot of layers to him, which you can find out more about that tomorrow at 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time on twitch.tv/EVC when I interview Void 101.
Woo! Good plug. So that means he's winning Genesis.
Or Genesis Saga. I'm covering Genesis my bases.
Okay.
Speaking of Day's Shit Talk, so, you know, Day got Shit Talk. You know, he Shit Talk fucking Zero for the run back, then immediately got bodied.
Yeah.
Right? So this guy... this fucking Jim, I had to use the term this time because it was 2016. Jim fucking hits me and he tweets, doesn't follow either one of us, by the way. He tweets us and says, wow, you guys are being hella biased. Or, no, you guys are being so biased toward Day, it's disgusting. And so I'm in the process of, like, writing this tweet back. And I'm like, but why? I don't know this nigga. He doesn't follow me. He doesn't have a lot of followers. It's not like anyone else is going to see this, but maybe his, like, little cronies. So yeah. I go over to Day, and I was like, Day. I was like, you need to get your mans. And he was like, why? And I was like, dude said I was like being biased towards you. I was like, but real shit, you got body. He was like, yeah, I got body. I was like, I can't talk you up if you're not doing shit. Like, you know what I mean? Like, I can't point out the one time you finally landed back here if you got hit 900 times before then. What the
yeah.
fuck? People don't understand bias in commentary, man. Now, if they was doing terrible and I just never talked about anything Zero was doing, that's fucking bias. You know what I mean? I'm just like, well, I mean, you know, you just got to give Day a couple hits, and I swear to God, he's going to take it back. Like, that's being biased. But if he's actually getting literally destroyed, then I have to exit the point that the man's getting destroyed. So whoever that guy was, fuck you. But, yeah. Forgot, I don't even remember his name. He just looked like lame, so.
Yeah. All right. Thunderdome says, thoughts on Zage entering the online Genesis qualifier twice on both days when you can only enter once? Was it a simple mistake?
Did he win both times, though?
He got DQ'd, I think. I don't know what happened. I know that there was apparently a shit-talking junior from Canada that he beat or something. I don't know. Zage seems like a nice guy. Like, I don't know him too well, but I feel like it must have just been a mistake, but maybe not. I don't know. Who cares, honestly? it's whatever. Unless he won, it didn't matter. So, speaking of which, actually, Wrath and Kool-Aid are in the top 8 for that. I don't know
so
who
is
else
M-
is in.
So is MJG.
MJG? Oh, good shit.
Yeah.
Really? I heard that he lost 2-0 to Cosmos, but...
made the run, man.
Wow. Okay, that's impressive.
I had to play Blanco for Glory today. He beat my Marth, and I beat him Wii Fit, and then I switched to Doc for some fucking reason. Because, like, honestly, I wasn't really trying to, like, go super hard anyway. But I just needed to know that I could actually beat his Junior. Junior is so annoying, dude. Junior is actually so annoying, like when you really put it in perspective, all the like a junior who literally just side B's all over the place.
Yeah.
But like not even like side B's in the hit you every time, so it's just a bunch of side B mix ups, that shit definitely starts to wear on your fucking mental traits, so
yeah.
Or mental fortitude.
Yeah.
Hearing that goddamn sound.
Yeah.
Oh, Mecha, Starman and Bert. It's Kool-Aid versus Percy and Rat versus Cosmos in winners. Mecha and Starman and MJG and Burst in losers.
Okay.
I don't even know two or three of them niggas.
Yeah, I was going to say, I never heard of them. Good for them, though. Good luck.
Being old.
All right, Wendy said, every time I go to my local, I ask to commentate, and Tio says, we'll see if we need you, never happens. So do I just keep trying, or no?
Why is your local being so fucking, like...
Why does your local care? Yeah.
I'm saying, like, you should at least be able to get some of the fucking first round matches, and if they keep doing that, man, let me know.
Seriously, let us know. We'll light them up.
Yeah, I'm saying, we had no problem lighting people up. That's the... We preach going to your local and... practicing commentary as much as you can until you've proven that you can't do shit on commentary. But even then, you know, if you have this real strong desire to the work, you know, no one's ever so bad that they can't get at least up to the point where they're a decent local commentator.
Absolutely, yeah.
Right. But, yeah, if they're just kind of shitting on you, not letting you get a chance, then, yeah, let me know.
You deserve the opportunity to at least try.
Yeah.
Which Wendy is this?
Name is Wendy Gox.
Oh yeah, that's Wendigo. Yeah, that's one of my subs. Hey, yeah, you definitely tell me. I come down there and kick some ass. Goddamn.
What region are they in?
Texas.
Wait, Wendigo the Toon Link player?
Mm. Wendy definitely plays more than Toon Link, but yeah, Wendigo, you know the name.
Yeah,
I know that. Yeah, he's a cool guy.
They can't get on commentary in Texas? Who the fuck is in Texas?
Right.
that just sounds like a boys club. Like, they just don't want you to do it for some reason. But fuck them. Tell them to do it. Let us know. We'll big brother that shit. Just let my boy on commentary. Everybody should be able to commentate locals. It's not hard. Like, if you want to do it, people should be, you know, pushing that forward. So, PJ says, do you have advice for not getting upset or tilted during matches? Sometimes I get so upset I want to cry in the middle of a match. PJ, maybe it's time to sort some stuff out.
Well, come on, let's give a benefit of doubt. Who are you playing? Because I've definitely had that moment, not of wanting to cry, but getting so upset that someone is literally, like, their play style is that annoying, that it only made me want to beat them, like, better. Like, the first few times I played Denobro. I'm actually, like, 5-1 to Denobro, but the first few times I played him, it almost always went to time. So every time I beat him, I kind of told him to go fuck himself.
Damn! He's so nice, dude.
This one I was good, though. No, because he was, like, literally trying to time me out. Like, I would win first game, and then he would just camp. So, like, I would get, like, it's like 5-4, up smash, kill, fuck yourself.
Damn. But did you want to cry, like, in the middle of the match?
I mean, it made me pretty sad. What up, Blanc?
A Blanc's in here? What's going on, Blanc? How's it going?
Junior head-ass, bitch-ass. Anyway.
Blanc, people in the chat were trash-talking you. Just wanted you to know. I don't think we said anything, did we?
Bowser Jr. is annoying. That has nothing to do with him. He just knows how to play the fucking character.
Oh, yeah, that was it. Yeah. All right. Any advice for not getting upset? I don't know, man. Like,
maybe listen to some classical music, man.
Breathe deep. Avery says, why is the phenomenal EE not rocking a pair of HyperX Cloud Stingers? My man is forced to wear earbuds. I mean, those are comfortable, man.
I have the Cloud Stingers. I wear them a lot of times when I play Overwatch or Rocket League. I'm just chilling right now. So I don't need to have more.
Alright, Harlan says, thoughts on what players on the old PGR you expect to move up or down on the next version? What player makes the greatest impact? We actually just talked about that at the beginning. Go ahead and watch the VOD. We only talked about, like, the top 15 or so players, because we don't want to go down the entire list. We'll talk about it when it's out, but for now, we don't have enough time to talk about every single person.
True.
If you have a question about a particular player, let us know, but we're not going to just go down everything. Sam McClure, do you think coaching is going to gain more prominence in Smash within the coming year? I think in Melee we're seeing some shifts. So, like, Tafo just got picked up by Cloud9 for being Mango's coach.
That's crazy.
That is crazy, yeah.
Like, that's crazy that coaches get picked up like that. But, you know, shout-outs to Captain Crunch. He was the first coach. He was the original coach.
Yeah.
Yep. Liquid Crunch.
Well, he was the original picked-up coach. I mean, the original coach is actually Coach Payne, but...
Yeah. Coach Payne. That's my boy. Yeah, I feel like there's... I don't know if, like, picking up coaches and, like, professional coaches is the best idea, because, like, a lot of events just ban coaching. So, like, what if you're...
Well, that's one thing that I heard a lot of people were saying, Melee is getting coaches now, they're going to change the rules for Melee. And they probably
D1?
D1 came through just for the Coach Payne!
Yo, what up, D-What?
That's my shit.
Oh, shit.
That's funny.
Yeah, they'll probably adjust some things. I've always been somebody who thinks, like, if you're esports, I love sports, right? I love regular sports. You coach all the time in that shit. Esports between, like, if somebody, if you're designated, like, I don't know, 20 to 30 seconds between a match, 15 to 20 seconds between a match, have somebody tell you some shit, I think that's perfectly fine. I don't think that's an issue. It's during the match that I dislike. That is not okay. Like, hey, watch it. And, bro, hey, watch out for Snake's Mind or some stupid shit like that. But, no, between the match, like, somebody to kind of settle you down, give you some quick advice, I think that's perfectly fine.
Yeah.
I think it's ridiculous that we actually don't, that we don't allow that, to be honest.
Yeah.
Maybe you can argue, too, like, okay, for, like, a certain part in the tournament, maybe for, like, top 64, not freaking pools or whatever, top 32. But, yeah, I think it's perfectly fine.
Yeah. All right, Chandler Mead says, evolution of Smash 4 in 2017. That's very broad. I think
Circuit, boys.
Circuit, yeah.
Circuit, boys.
Circuit's going to be the thing to watch. Yeah. Nierat says, Coney subs meet up at MAGFest. Maybe. I don't know which of my subs are going. I know you're going Fred Gertz. Is probably going. If you guys are going, go hang out. Yeah. All right. Alan Holder says, I know this isn't related, but EE, who are your wild card weekend picks?
You're talking about football?
He's probably talking NFL. Yeah.
You know, hit me up later in my stream. Let me take a look at the bracket and really think about it. I don't want to give a definitive picks right now. But yeah, hit me up. Hit me up later in my stream.
Yeah. I'll give you some picks. Chandler Mead, do you think we will see more of MK Leo on the 2017 circuit? Yes. Scribe, will Leo ever take first spot from Zero? Maybe.
Possibly.
Could be, yeah.
Great question. Next.
you gotta ask, like, not yes or no questions. Because, like, he has the potential to, but, like, we can't say that, man. Like, yeah, we don't know.
You know, one thing I'd like to point out, too, although he does have the potential, like, people just kind of, they kind of discredit Zero in a way, right? And I think it's because they're just so desperate for, like, a new definitive number one, right? We just want somebody who's not Zero to be the go-to guy who we think is going to do it.
Absolutely.
And this 15-year-old kid from Pueblo, Mexico is the guy we want. I'm here to tell you that Zero has not made, did not build the greatest winning streak in Smash 4 for no reason. He's not dominated for so long. You think he can't adapt and adjust and keep things and make things very interesting, you're going to be sorely disappointed in 2017.
Absolutely, yeah. Kudios, have you guys ever considered campaigning the push of static teams more? I know TK has talking about, like, Team CLG and stuff.
No one fucking cares, man. It's a hard thing to push. I don't understand why people don't like the idea of playing more teams. This game even gave us more options of doing teams, but it always seems to be a side of it. Because I think, one, people don't like to depend on other people to do well, but
right.
I don't know, man. When you have, it's just fun to me, man. It's just fun.
Yeah. Doubles is a passion project, like we were saying before. Like, it's different. All right, Blake Ferguson says, is Esam going to be salty about his placement? I don't think so. Esam's very reasonable in terms of, like, knowing his skill for the most part. Yeah. He overrates his character sometimes, but
He's very true to himself. Like, if Esam gets fucked up, he'll say he got fucked up, but if Esam wins, he's going to talk about himself winning. People just hate that shit, so they hate seeing him win.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'd like to see, Esam is, he'll be all right, man. I mean, he got second at Shine, and then he got top eight at freaking UGC. You know, he double eliminated Void. That ain't easy to do. But Esam, I'm gonna talk to you about Don't Park on the Grass. Why are you losing some random Game & Watch who lost the next two rounds? Nigga, I know that matchup is difficult for Pikachu, but you have a Corrin. Okay? I don't want any excuses. Win next time. Switch off. Ridiculous. You're in that bullshit. Scrub. Come on now.
Alright, so he's gonna post an excuse in the chat and I'm gonna time his ass out. No excuses.
It's coming.
He's gonna see this late. I'm waiting for it.
You tell your core can't beat a nigga who went 0-2 after he beat you? Come on, boy.
Where is it? There it is. Boom. He's gone. Bow. No excuses, my boy. God. No excuses.
For 600 at that, that's crazy.
Sniped! Take that hot 600. There we go.
All right, he said he went Mewtwo. Should've went Corrin, dog. Should've went Corrin. Corrin Rex game and what?
Alright, here we go. I let you back out, Esam. I don't know if he saw that. I let him out. He tweeted immediately. Alright, here we go. Let me see. Proofy says, what was your favorite tournament? You mean of this year? Or do you mean, like, in general? Because in general, I'm not going to answer that. Because, come on.
And this year, man, we always go with what tournament had the best production value and all that good shit. So I'm going to have to give it to either UGC or Shine.
Yeah.
As far as, like, Hangout, it was definitely smashed the record, but UGC and Shine were the two tournaments that I was like, damn, this is some good-ass production. And damn, they did. They're definitely treating us right. So.
Yeah. And they both pay us our.
Yeah.
But can't disclude that. I gotta go with for this year. I gotta go with Shine, man. UGC was fantastic, but I just hated the area. And so there was enough to do.
Oh, that area sucked. Yeah.
Yeah. Shine was in Boston, man. It was in the summertime. Just beautiful. Just always something to do, man. Great venue. Hotel was right there. Absolutely
Shake Shack.
Shine. Yeah, Shake Shack. Absolutely loved Shine. Can't say a bad word about it.
I wish I went to Shine. I might say that. Honestly, for me, this is kind of a selfish pick, because, like, if I'm talking about, like, gameplay and the experience, I'm going to say Genesis. But for me personally, I'm going to say UGC, because of the lower attendance, but all, like, the top-level players, I got to interact and, like, talk with players that I don't really get to spend a lot of time with. So, like, we all went out to Steak and Shake. I got to talk with, like, D1 more. I got to talk with Matt.Zeb. Got to talk with DC a lot more, who I did a ton of commentary with. I got to, like, get to know these guys better. And usually at events, I don't talk to people at that level all that much. I'm usually pretty busy, and I'm not like that. But it was really eye-opening, and I had a really good time talking to people. So just having that experience, for me personally, that was my favorite thing.
By the way, man, I don't think your dude likes me, man.
Don't think who likes?
Your Smash and Splash homie, man, I don't think he likes me.
Though. Oh, he's cool as shit. I don't know what to tell you about that. I don't.
He doesn't like me, though. Like, you introduced yourself, and y'all were hugging it out and blah, 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 and I was like, oh, I guess I'll introduce myself to this guy. You were, Cody, my guy, my dude, Cody, oh, I love you, man. And I was like, oh, what's up, man? You know, like, I was talking to the girl next to him, the redhead chick. She was talking to us earlier, and I was like, yeah, we're going to party, whatever, whatever. And then, like, when we went to go get food, like, before I walked off, I was like, yo, by the way, man, I'm CK Breezy. And he was like, yeah. Like,
yeah.
Yeah, I was like it was the weakest handshake. I was like, this nigga does not respect me. It was like I was like, yo, I'm TK's.
Oh, the limp handshake.
I was like, all right, bitch. Yes. Come to your fucking tournament.
The limp handshake is rough.
He's cool. I don't know how the experience went, but he's a really cool guy. Josh is awesome. SmashCon, the reason I didn't say SmashCon was awesome because I got to meet a ton of my subs, and it was great. It was awesome. But I don't think this SmashCon, if I'm being honest, I don't think it was as good as the year before. I still think it was a great event, but I don't think it was to the same level.
Wow, come on, man. Are you serious?
I don't think so.
We went legendary.
I mean, we did great. I'm talking about the event. It didn't feel as big to me as the first SmashCon. And that might just be because of, like, the top eight, or, like, the, because, like, ESAM had that really awesome run. Maybe it's just, I felt like SmashCon this year, and I heard it from a lot of people that SmashCon this year wasn't as great. That's all.
Maybe they try to do too much, but I enjoyed the event. I hear what you're saying.
I loved it. It was like my number two or number three, but I, you know, if I'm talking, like, gameplay-wise, I'm going to say Genesis. Personal-wise, I'm going to say, you know, UGC. SmashCon was great, but... let me see. Alright, let me see. Nick2D2 says, what is everyone's thought on the Smashbox? I think it could be pretty cool.
I'm okay with it.
That's a heated debate, man. I see both sides.
Oh, I gotta tell Ashley she can come over. Oops. Go ahead.
I'm not gonna say anything about it. People smarter than me and more in the know than me can talk about it. I'm not gonna use it, so I don't care. But I see both sides. Gimmer is on one side, Blur is on the other, just in terms of, like, you know, notable people. If you want my opinion, I feel like it's more of a Melee thing, because the whole argument is, like, the technical execution barrier of Melee is one of its defining attributes, so people want to maintain that integrity. And on the other side, people are saying, yeah, but your bones are going to be fucking dust by the time you're 28. Like, so, do you want arthritis, or do you want, you know, this integrity and this romanticism of how hard the game is? So I see both sides. Do you guys have a strong opinion either way?
I'm just okay with it.
I don't care.
Yeah, I mean, until player number 90 goes from going 0-2 to every tournament to placing first because he started using Smashbox, then I'm just okay with it.
Yep. PJ said, did Larry Lur get kicked off of Team Elegant because he broke Melee discs? Maybe. Well, piss somebody off.
Elevate. I feel like Larry left and he's about to get picked up by someone else.
That's what everybody thinks.
Like literally... within, like the Nairo drop. Nairo was off of liquid for like 3 days. And next thing you know, it's NRG.
Yeah.
I called that shit too, and he didn't admit it.
That's funny. Sam McClure, do you have any guests you'd like to have on Blast Zone in the near future? We were supposed to do guests, but we have this cool layout by Keith the Human. You see all this shit going on down here? It's awesome. So it does not make for guests.
It
does
not matter.
We gotta go ahead and fix that. But in terms of like guests on Blast Zone, anybody, dude, anybody's welcome to come on. Well, not anybody. A lot of people are welcome to come on. I would like, you know, I would like anybody just because like. I like having different perspectives. I've had, like, Tantalus on before. We had a bunch of people from other games come on sometimes.
Who could forget that memorable episode with Tito?
Tito's been on, yeah. Tito's been on as well. So, we have a bunch of people on.
Yeah, great pick, Connie.
Can I say something real quick about the Larry thing?
Yeah.
I see some comments in the chat. Guys, remember, when somebody leaves a team, it doesn't mean that team is shit. It means they might have just got able to go into greener pastures or whatever. Like, don't, you know, Elevate, I know a couple of those guys, they're really nice. You know, it's not that maybe they couldn't do everything Larry wanted them to do for him, and he's getting a better offer, but you know, don't think that they're just trash. Like, we know what a GarageBand Esports is. Like,
yeah,
you know, we know what those teams are. They're ass, and Elevate's not one of those teams.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, Elevate, at the very least, is a Tier 2 team. I mean, at the very least. And, you know, we're not talking, as you said, Garage Esports Tier 5. Well, we could pay for one of your hotel rooms.
Yeah.
Or one of your days at the hotel. Yeah. That's about it. I'm one of those teams.
Yeah.
Pay your venue fee at your local. Still need 30% of your winnings, though.
Yeah. Speaking of Tito, here's a question from Tito. Tito asks, do you think the saturation of events will dilute the level of top-tier commentary like EE, D1, TK, etc. can't be everywhere?
Not really.
I don't think so, because like if they're at an event, but two other people are at a different event, and they're both doing top 8, odds are the top 8 that these guys are doing are at the bigger event.
Only time we got the smaller event was Glitch 2, and we still destroyed them in commentary, apparently, so.
Hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's, yeah, it. I don't think so. I hear what you're saying, but I don't think so.
What do you mean?
No, not you. I meant Tito.
Oh, I heard Tito say. I was like, hey, I read the threads, okay?
No. No, we killed it. Rex Ryan, hey, Coney, even with solid placements with Duck Hunt in Japan, do you share the same stupid opinion with Esam and Gunblade that Duck Hunt is bottom 5? Jesus.
What an aggressive question.
I was going to say, like, kind of a loaded question on that one. Esam's right there. Like, he's watching this. I don't have an opinion either way. I'm constantly surprised by the shit that comes up in this game, so, like, I'm not going to be the guy to be like, oh yeah, Duck Hunt's terrible, because I'm not a player at that level. I suck. So why am I going to talk, you know? I was more surprised about who had somebody at Pac-Man at second worst. Was it Mr. R? It was somebody recently.
I mean, Pac-Man's pretty ass.
Yeah, maybe it was... He said,
second worst, remember. Though. That's
probably not second worst. That's crazy.
Yeah, I meant second worst, yeah. And
if Gan is not at the bottom of your list at all times, I don't even care about your list. Like... Who the fuck is losing to Ganon? Jigs, I guess?
That was also me. Okay, so it was Esam. Yeah, Esam said Pac-Man is second worst. That's kind of surprising.
Wow. Man, I just saw Orpheus say this nigga is salty, and I can never picture Orpheus saying nigga in real life. Wow.
That's what I'm with. Like, don't be a keyboard warrior, bro. I never heard you say that word.
Orpheus.
Don't be a keyboard warrior, man. We're gonna see you tomorrow. Like, what the fuck?
Shout out to Orpheus.
All right, Coke says, do any E3 have good deals with DX Racer? My ass needs to ascend.
No,
I don't think
anymore.
So. I think Smash Studios might. They might have a code.
Yeah, they got. I mean, they got sponsored by them.
Yeah,
so,
real?
Yeah, that's on their banner.
I would really be out here talking. They're faking his number.
Yeah. Kestrophanus Bork says, who has the potential to become the next Tier 1 commentator? So we were talking about this before. That's a good question. It's a very good question.
I don't want to give that answer because I feel like I'm going to end up saying someone that some people already believe is a Tier 1 commentator.
You don't want to, yeah.
And I don't want to, like, shit on them. Yeah. So.
Because
my Tier 1 is definitely just me, EE, D1, and, well, I mean, whenever you fucking go somewhere.
I'm 1.5.
Yeah, you
I'm 1.5. I don't go to
you little jerk.
I feel
stop being an adult.
Yeah, that's all. I feel like, well, EE, do you have one? Because, like, I know that there have been, like, we talk a lot about commentators, like, behind closed doors, we talk about ones that we really like and, like, people on the come up, but, like...
Oh, about who I think can really, like,
come up. Who can up ascend, and, like...
Oh, I mean, I fully 100%, I back Austin all the way, man. Like, he's a homie. I've seen the improvement. He's dedicated. He gets himself out there on his own dime. One thing he ever asked me to do is try to help him get these spots, which I do. Talked about at UGC and Zero Saga, but I know people are still on the fence about Austin. I understand that, but like just knowing him as a person, like, and his stats are also equally impressive. By the way, he has some really good fucking stats.
Yeah,
that guy has a lot of potential. I saw people say like Pluto in the chat too. Yeah, Pluto's great. Pluto is definitely a fantastic guy as well. Maybe you can say East Coast, West Coast versions of each other. But yeah, man.
Yeah,
I back Austin all the way. That's my boy.
I think that the most important thing we could say right now is, like, it looks like a lot of people are passionate in the chat about commentators that you love. That's awesome. You guys should do that. Please support your favorite commentator. If there's ever an opportunity for them to be, like, taken out to an event, if 2GG is ever like, hey, who do you guys want to see? Please support them, no matter who it is. We need that. Like, your favorite commentator could be, like, you know, days from quitting. You know what I mean? Because it's a hard job. It was harder in the past. It's a little bit easier now because we have a little bit more support. But, like, please support your favorite commentator. If they're doing something that you like, shoot them a tweet. Let them know. They need that feedback. So please, you know, let us know what you guys think is good, what you guys think we could work on. I'm seeing a lot of love for people, you know, that other people may not have even heard of. Like, we need that. So, you know, please, please, please support whoever you love. Always. All right, Parappa said, TK, how'd I do on commentary last Tuesday? It was fun to commentate with you.
People think you're a little cocky, if you want to be completely honest. I mean, but I think you already knew that. And you got to stop talking about yourself so much. That is a really bad trap for most commentators, where like you feel like you need to interject yourself or your story into the current match, and that's not really much. That's not really as important as you would think it is. Other than that, man, I think you did fine. You said valid points. You have a very good speaking voice, and we had good flow. So
yeah, there you go. Good. J Dog says, do you think a commentators union would be feasible for Smash to help guarantee minimum payments, rights, etc.?
No, nigga,
that's a tricky wicket. I don't know.
No, and it's, I'm saying no because of, like, real shit, like, we're not all out here as brothers anymore. Like, That time where everyone's trying to get everyone up there is gone. Like, it's gone, and if you don't believe it, if you don't see it, it's only because you're trying to play that nice guy role. But everyone fucking knows, like, at the end of the day, you're going to be there for yourself. Like, yeah, man, I told Coney I'd give him the BAM spot because he was wanted, but Tony's my boy. Now, you think that if, like, one of, like, these other commentators who I don't really associate with that much was like, man, I really want to go to fucking Australia, man, I really... can't wait, and, you know, if they don't vote me in, and like, it's over for me, I'm like, all right, well, she better do better, nigga, because, like, the fuck,
yeah.
Like, this is about me, nigga, this ain't about you, and like that, so this commentary union, everyone's, like, we're never going to agree on it, because everyone is going to want what I believe we deserve, and everyone doesn't deserve that, and then when I say that, I'm going to be the asshole who said that, so,
yeah,
just not doing that.
I hear you. Yeah, I think that it's kind of a pipe dream. But I think that it doesn't stand to, like, I don't know, it's tricky. I'm not one to talk about it. You guys can talk about it because you guys are at the higher level. You guys are going to events all the time. I shouldn't give an opinion, but I hear what you're saying.
I just talk that shit. Niggas respect it. Fuck with
you. He's very astute.
I mean, you actually haven't said anything. That's the funniest part about it. Like, I said everything, but somehow
I agree with that shit.
Somehow he talked that shit.
I co-signed that shit. Where's my pen? See this big ass pen, nigga? I co-signed. We out.
Good shit.
You're watching Disney Channel.
Speaking of which, you guys see that Orlando Brown shit?
Yeah.
Good God, dude.
That was the greatest. That was the greatest video ever.
Real shit, I watched that shit twice, man.
I hit the button. I was like, why is he And then it was just right there in my face, like.
My man went turbo drive for the last 30 seconds of that video.
Orlando the God.
Turbo-tastic, like, that's my boy. Alright, Emba said, when are we going to see Blazin top 8 again, like Smash Con? I don't know. hit up your tournament. We were going to do it at UGC, but we had technical issues, so.
Yeah.
Ask for it, and maybe it'll happen. I don't know. I mean, like, I never ask for it because I don't want to step on these guys' toes. These guys deserve doing their own shit, but if we're ever at an event and we feel it happening, you know.
We always ask.
It'll happen. Them. Yeah. Well, I mean, if you guys want to hit me up and you want to do it, that's fine. I don't want to be like, hey, can I play? Like, you know what I mean? Like, you guys you guys built yourself up. You guys earned it. That's all.
So. We're those two top players at a tournament set up trying to, like, get that practice.
I'm just a fucking random. Like,
hey, can I get a set?
Next.
What?
Doubles? Doubles? I'm not doing that, so. I'm not trying to turn a 1v1 into a free-for-all. I'll just say that, so. Anyway, we'll see. We'll see. Definitely glitches. I think glitches in the future. I don't know about SmashCon, but we'll see. Anyway. But thank you for the question. Zapper says, do you think esports organizations will begin to sponsor commentators for their content creation as most commentators stream?
We're trying, man. We're trying. That's all I can say. I'm not... By the way, I'm only wearing the COG shit because I went together. I'm not sponsored by them or any even in the works on that deal that I know.
Yeah, I went for that. They said no. They have no spots right now.
Mm. Ah, okay. That sucks. So, yeah, man, we're trying, but we're also not going to just take any fucking sponsorship just like these players out here, you know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
If you ain't got no fucking benefits from me, then what? You know, if I had more followers than you, I'm definitely not going to take it.
Yeah.
Especially if I have, like, a shit. Like, if you're at, like, 30K, but I'm at 35K, I'm like, all right. But, like, if you had like 2K, don't come to my inbox, dog.
Back when we were playing PM, I got hit up by a few like garage esports things, and one of them was Big Chief, which is like an Indian thing. And they said that they were gonna send me out like a t-shirt and an Indian headdress that was like part of their package. I was like, I'm not fucking wearing feathers on stream. Like, are you fucking kidding me? Like a war chief. Like it's the dumbest shit. The gimmicks are crazy. Just don't do that. If you have like less followers than like other people, just don't do it, man. Don't do it. All right. Let me see. FGP. Big Chief Gaming, man. They're trying to make me like the war chief of MDVA. I wasn't doing it. FGP says, seeing as you're all commentators, if you had to coin one phrase each, what would it be? Says FGP. Like D1's destruction. I mean, I don't have one.
Oh, mine's definitely body.
Oh, unbelievable.
Oh, there you go.
You haven't said that shit in forever.
It still has notoriety, damn it.
That's true. I'm waiting for that day that comes back.
It's coming back, man.
Because when it comes back, I'm gonna just like when they cut back to us, I'm just gonna be like,
coming back, man.
Concerned Mike, this is Doc Pickle, says, hit us with the New Year resolutions. Do you guys have some?
I do, but I don't want to get teased.
Okay.
Taunting and body is also me, apparently. And scoops, nah, that's yikes. I just brought it to Smash. That's definitely yikes, though. So I don't really have any like New Year's resolutions. I have some goals, which is basically so 2015 actually, I was talking to DM and he told me that I should really push the aesthetic of the Black Plague, blah blah blah, and I was like, well, why would I do that? He barely even tries, which was true at the time, and he was like, yeah, but you guys are the best duo, blah, 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 blah. So 2016 rolls around, he starts to fucking try, and I was like, all right, cool. So 2017, I'm trying to just push that. Just push the Black Plague in all narratives, in all aspects. And I got called out for this one time by Sky, who was like, he thinks that we're monopolizing or gentrifying the commentary gameplay, or the commentary game by, you know, branding as a duo that is now blocking out anyone else's chance for getting like a top 8 spot. And I was like, so why don't you just get a duo? Like, it's better to have two people who have worked together for a long period of time than to have two good commentators work together for the first time at top 8. Like, that doesn't sound that great at all. So basically that's it. I mean, brand out for Black Plague, get 400 subs, and stream 100 hours a month. That's it.
Yeah.
My resolution is to maintain over 300 subs. I just passed 300 subs. That's pretty cool. Thanks, everybody who subs, supported.
Yay!
To get another 10,000 followers on Twitch. to have us continue to do a lot of good stuff in Smash, and eventually we want to break into Rocket League. So if anybody has any Rocket League contacts, hit us up.
Yeah.
And I would like to lose a bit of weight, and I'm actively trying to. And yes. So, thank you.
You should. Whoa! I tried to post something, and then it just came up as a Google thing. Alright,
Oh, get a job in esports, by the way.
Job in esports?
Yeah. Well, that was my other thing, but I haven't really put anything into it. But I think I can actually get a job at either Discord or Muxy if I really, like, apply myself. But
where are they based out of?
Muxy is in Austin, which I'm okay with, and Discord is in San Fran or San Jose, one or the other. So, I mean, like, either way, I'd still be fine. And then on top of that, having a job and being a streamer and being a commentator, it's not like I can't get out to a thing. So.
Yeah.
All right. Overall, we're just kind of done with, like, doing locals.
I got you. A1 since day one says, would good local commentators do top 64 and you would have tier 1 do top 8? Is that format good? I don't even know. Good local commentators probably aren't going to do top 64. They're probably going to do, like, pools and stuff if it's, like, a super national. Top 64 would be, like, tier 3 or 4. And then you move up. So top 32 is tier 3. Top 16 is tier 2. Top 8 is tier 1. And again, it's not a good idea to tier commentators usually because, it's so subjective and, like, it's not really fair, but I feel like we're at the point where we're seeing the same faces in a lot of these places. So, like, if we're going to standardize anything, if we need to standardize, like a lot of people are saying we need to, that needs to be determined. That's all. So, thank you, D-Disciple, for 15 months. Yo, can I get a buddy pass?
Right. Quick shout-out to Mary Contreras, by the way. I met her at Twitch Con.
Mm-hmm.
I had the panel with Discord. I met her there. She gave me this, like, her card was on this wood piece. I think she, like, whittled herself.
That's so awesome.
Like, yeah, so now it's you know how, like, those things that you have to pull to open your blinds?
Yeah.
Well, one of them, like, fell off, so now I tied that around, so I always have it. It's pretty cute, though.
That is cute. So, that's cool.
Yeah. Anyway.
Let me see. Roger Sierra, Coney, let's be real, Donkey Kong 64 is better than Banjo-Kazooie. Can you please type in the chat so I can time you out? Let me know.
Please get timed out right now.
You're shit. You are shit, and your opinion shit. Walrus Industry says, when is the right time to put down Christmas lights? Fun fact, Mallory actually told me this. Apparently Christmas isn't over until January 8th, because that's when the three wise men got to Jesus. Did you guys know that? I didn't know.
Okay, I knew that.
That's not bad. If I see a Christmas light anytime past, like, January 15th, I'm starting to judge. And if I see him in February, then we probably got scrapped. Straight up. Ding dong, hello? Square up, nigga.
I think mine need to be up, though, because, like, I have MAGFest, then Genesis, then I got shit for two other weekends. So don't come by my place. Don't fight me, please. You got reach on me. Silver G, have you guys thought about or tried to commentate other games? If you did it go well?
I did a little bit of commentary for Injustice while I was playing it, and it went fine. But it's hard. I don't know what it is about, like, the FGC, but it's really hard for me to, like, feel, like, comfortable. You know what I mean? Like, in that setting, because I always feel like we came from that aesthetic of always being judged by them, so it's like I don't feel comfortable in that setting.
Yeah.
And then of course Rocket League, but I haven't really found anyone.
Yeah.
I want to do Rocket League at some point, maybe even Overwatch, who the hell knows, but that's good luck getting in that. But yeah. I used to commentate Yu-Gi-Oh! On the Alter Reality Games circuit. I really enjoyed doing that. I'd love to go back to it, but I just don't have the time anymore between Smash and streaming. But, I'm not uncomfortable commentating something else. It's all about just getting the opportunity and then putting the work in.
Yep.
I mean, I commentated Pokken at DreamHack. And I barely knew what the hell I was talking about. Hey, man, I'm not going to pass up a trip to DreamHack.
That's funny.
I could have did Pokken too, but I think my Twitter was unclean at the time.
Yeah.
So.
Heck said.
At this point in time, I'm kind of, like, not even caring about that anymore because, like, we kept it clean for, like, almost. I feel like I kept it clean for almost the entire year, and I feel like nothing really is. Like, no new companies or anything has, like, approached me, and I even went back and erased all, like, I literally name searched and erased every tweet that had, like, any type of curse word in it, and I was just like, this feels arbitrary.
Yeah.
I feel like I'm not even me anymore. But oh well.
I got you. Hexetera says, do you feel like streamers of big tournaments should utilize sub mode to give their subs a chance at having a chat experience? No. I feel like Clash did that, and that got a lot of shit. I hear what you're saying, but I don't think that's a good idea.
The best thing that came out of when Clash did that was because, like, I guess they only have like 10 subscribers or whatever. But nobody was talking when you put it in sub mode. And this one person subbed, and they typed in the chat, yeah, I subbed just to say fuck you. Got banned.
Wasn't like D-Disciple in there like, hey, I'll let out sub mode if like 5 people follow me on Twitter. Like, it's like, Jesus.
It was so legendary.
Yeah, if you did that, man, you lame, dog.
I don't know if it's D-Disciple.
If he did it, though, he's lame.
No,
right now.
All right. Yeah, anyway, I hear what you're saying. I don't think so. I feel like the best chance for that is, like, sub-communities should use their own, like, poverty chats. So, like, I've had, you know, all my subs hacks. I'm pretty sure you've been in there. Like, all my subs get together and watch, like, an event that I'm hosting or something. Because, like, no chat is going on in, like, Zero Saga stream. It's just fucking, it's the normal Twitch chat experience. So, let me see. Kaladin, do you guys think Taunt to Get Bodied has run its course as a joke?
Maybe.
I don't think it's a joke anymore. I just think it's a fact of life. Like, it's just something that happens in Smash now. Like, you don't say it as a joke. It's just like, oh, that happened. Like, you know.
Yeah, I didn't see it as a joke. I mean, this shit just happened.
I mean, this shit really just happened.
Yeah.
Like, I mean, like, if I don't really know other times people are using it, and I'm sure it gets used over a lot. Yo, speaking of, I'm gonna need. I love you, Rob, but you gotta stop using my fucking sign, dog. You gotta stop using my sign, dog. I've seen too many clips of Rod using the body sign. Y'all niggas need to stop, okay?
Oh, I saw that at one event, and I was like,
y'all niggas need to stop, okay? This shit is getting a little old. Anyway, Time to Get Body started for me and Paragon Orlando, and it has just been true ever since.
Yeah, it's not really a joke. It's just something that, like, happens, you know? It's all the time. Cinemod says, thank you, TK, for the knowledge last week. Still a noob. And he wants to know, how much more commentary will you all do as opposed to last year?
Wait, who said that?
Cinemod?
Said, thank you for
Cinemod.
What?
Cinemod. He said, thanks, TK, for the knowledge last week. He's still a noob. So I guess you talked to him last week. I don't know.
I mean,
he said thank you. Maybe you tweeted at him. In terms of how much more commentary we're going to do this year, I can't speak for these guys. I'm going to try to do more, if only because more events will be like having people fly out and taking people out. I mean, you guys are trying to do the whole circuit, right? TGG?
Well, we're definitely trying to do the whole fucking circuit.
Yeah, definitely.
I mean, even if we don't even want like every top 8 either, like, I don't know. I wouldn't even care about getting top 8. I just want to get at least a top 16 or like some primetime spot. So if you just had the Black Plague do top 16 in every fucking 2GG and had Bam and D1 do top 8, I wouldn't give a shit. I just want to go. I just want to go and be part of that history.
Or D1 Pluto, some combination.
Like, yeah, something. You know, it doesn't matter to us. We just want to go.
Yeah. All right. We're gonna.
I want to be at everyone after Genesis. For the record.
I think we're going to go ahead and lightning round these last few questions because we're coming up at 10 o'clock. 10 o'clock is usually where we want to cut it out. So I'm going to lightning round these questions. We're going to answer these quick. We're trying to get to all of these, so hit us up now if you got anything you really want to know. But let's go quick. Scribe says, Locus now has wins on Tweak. Mr. R and Daft, do you see him overtaking Trella? Pretty sure Trella
retired? I don't know why we're still bringing his name up. He hasn't gone anything or did anything notable in quite some time.
Trella actually got dropped from PG today.
Yeah, he just got dropped.
Yeah.
He got dropped because he doesn't... I mean, like, nothing against him. You know, if mental issues, depression, like, I understand all that. But he got really, really depressed, stopped playing, and they were, like, trying to get him help, and he didn't ever want to help, so they dropped him. But Trella would always talk shit about other Ryus, like, as they were doing well. Like, oh, man, here I am advancing the metagame, and all these Ryus are herp derp. Up till Shoryuken. I mean, but are you really advancing the metagame by trying to do riskier shit but not, like, winning? Like, you know what I mean? Like, maybe you don't need to do all that. I think what he should have said was, I want to be a flashier player, and it's just not working out for me. So, Trella honestly just needs to stop being brought up as far as Ryu is. When 2017 starts, or not with 2017 Jones. As 2017 goes on, I think we should just stop bringing his name up unless we're talking about Legacy.
Yeah,
I mean, you know, and I know the PG guys. Like, I talked to David. I know him really well. And they wanted to give Trello, like, the help he needed. They were willing to bring him out to an event, you know, such as even Zero Saga, just to, like, just be there. Maybe try and have him commentate. Just show his face, but he just wouldn't go. So, I mean, you know, at some point you got to make the call.
Yeah.
It's a shame. He had a lot of talent.
Yeah. Josh says, how do you feel about Marth right now as a random? I don't get why Marth is doing so well right now.
Marth potentially top 10, but no higher. No top 5, no top 7. I'm talking about, like, he's probably either 9th, 10th, or in that area. Like, 10th, from 9th to, like, 13th is where Marth's area is.
Right yeah. Now. Yep. That's basically it. If you're asking why Marth is good, it's because he can kill very early from Tipper and has lots of ways to get people in that situation. What about Tweak, though? Says big, tiny guy. Tweak, probably 15 to 20. He's around that, I think. Hi.
Man, Scar got a kid and lost the sponsor?
You go to sleep.
Wait, what?
So, Scar works for Twitch. Yeah, I think he's sponsored well enough.
Until I
end
up.
Okay. Why are you laughing? That's funny.
Just make sure you take him out.
Yeah. Okay. All right, love you. Sorry. Yeah, 15 to 20. Is that what you guys said?
Yeah, well, I said 9th to, like, 15. Okay. So, basically. So, like, if he was in top 10, he's not getting any higher than 9th. Like, and, like, I mean, that's if, like, 20XX or 20, I guess, FE started and everyone just played Marth and had a really good one.
Yeah.
So, oh, Mortal Kombat Scar. I was going to say, what the fuck? Anyway.
Oh, okay. I got you. Yeah. I mean, I don't know. I don't know why he got dropped. I thought he was pretty good at Mortal Kombat. But
yeah.
That's just a personal thing, though.
Raycat says, would it be cool to see general tips or matchup info similar to what SF5 does for players? Player 1 is adaptable, etc. Unrivaled Tournaments is actually already doing that. They have, like, 3 adjectives that describe players. So, like, Mr. R is, like, calculating. Void is explosive. They have things for everybody. I don't know how much they're being shown. They do it sometimes. Maybe they need to do it more. But that's becoming a thing. I think that's on commentators to kind of build that.
I think, yeah, that's pretty much on us. But also, if we're talking about, like, things that can push players in, or I would like to see more narrative on, like, I guess more interviews on, like, top players. But also, I want to see more narrative on the characters in the game. Street Fighter's been doing this thing for Season 2 called, like, Whatever Character at a Glance. And it's, like, a video just kind of showcasing a little bit of, like, of what makes them good and what makes them bad. I would like that to be done for Smash 4 characters, too. But, like, I don't know how that's going to play out because everyone wants to act like they know everything. So, yeah, at some point in time, that video is going to be very basic now. It's like, Mario is really good at up smashing, blah, 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 and has really good combos. And so someone's going to see that part of the video at the beginning. Wow, this video is fucking stupid. But, like, as you get deeper into the video, it could be, like, up smash kills at this range, blah, 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 on most characters, blah, blah, blah. These are good setups that you could potentially use. I would like to see stuff like that, but I don't know if we're ever going to do that.
Yeah. Sam McClure, do you think we'll see more banned team combinations like Sheik and Game & Watch? Why would we?
Yeah, man, no. Next.
That stuff's been figured out. Yeah.
Yeah, you're good on that, man. I think everything's pretty much... Is Sheik and Game & Watch still banned?
I don't think so. Not anymore, because they nerfed that, I thought.
Yeah, I don't think there's any banned combinations anymore. So.
No.
I mean, yeah.
Some people
have said Double Cloud needs to go, but I don't agree with that.
I think that Cloud, like, scared people for a while because of how strong Finishing Touch is, but, like, that got nerfed, and then I don't think it's crazy. Cloud has been... Thank you, Papaya Chunks, for the sub.
It's not even Double Cloud, though. It's just having a Cloud on your team.
Cloud plus anybody.
Infinitely make your team better.
Yeah.
So, you know, because I really haven't seen too many Double Clouds doing well, but Cloud plus Sheik, Cloud plus ZSS, Cloud plus Diddy, all these teams are just... It's always at the top.
Any
top
character with a throw is better with Cloud. So,
yep. Please throw them this way. Yeah.
Yeah! That's what that move is. Yeah! Get out of my face! Alright, Prime says, what do you think the Smash 4 community needs to do to become a main stage Evo game for 2017? I don't know.
Nothing. That's not even up to
blow us. Mr. Wizard. Cullen says, is it possible to be too esports? Because sometimes I feel like we're trying too hard and lose our roots. That's kind of corny, man. Like,
that's lame, dude. We're supposed to lose our roots. Like, we're supposed to lose our roots, and that's the problem with Smash, man. Everyone thinks that we're supposed to keep doing these Root tournaments. You know, everything that starts as Root was with the potential of us becoming a major esports. Like, if you guys are going to be mad about that, let's just start throwing shittier tournaments so they stop looking at us. Like,
yeah, man. You got to stop. You got to get out that you know, Motel 6 Holiday Inn mindset. I'm trying to go to the Ritz-Carlton, you feel me? You got to think bigger.
Yeah.
Because that's what we want out of this game. You don't have to lose yourself to gain what the game deserves, what the players deserve.
Yep.
What you, the audience, deserves. Come on, man.
You don't have to lose what makes it great to, like, get bigger. I hear what you're saying, like, saying you feel like we're trying too hard and losing the Roots, but, like, a lot of people say that without even knowing what that means. Like, they just want a reason to, like, maybe you have a legitimate reason, but most people that say that don't even know what that means. Like, they just don't get that. They just want to say it, like, and their answer is like, oh, well, nobody cusses anymore. Okay? Like, that, you I'm don't sorry. Need to curse. Like, you don't need to curse to get off a point. Like, I don't...
I didn't know that was really defining the commentary of the metagame. Like, you know what, man? I really like how he accentuates that knowledge he's dropping just by saying, fucking F-Smash. Like, that's just coming out on frame fucking 6. Like, what a good ass.
All right, Dan Ugor says, if hypothetically Smash 4 got Sunday at EVO this year, do you think it would re-encourage more top players to attend? Maybe. I don't know.
Well, I mean, it would be nice. I mean, honestly, I'd like to see every top 8 game on Sunday get that good, crisp ESPN coverage that Street Fighter got, you know what I mean? That freaking turned, what was that, L.I. Joe into a damn star. Like, even more so,
yeah,
right?
That's
like,
true.
That's crazy. Like, that's... Like, other games deserve that kind of attention. Smash 4, based on their entrance, definitely deserve to be on Sunday. I don't know why that was even a debate. But, I mean, you know.
Whatever.
Yeah.
Evil Wizard, LOL.
Evil Wizard, man. That's,
or Mr. Wizard,
you know,
whatever.
I just kind of knew that he didn't give a shit about us. First time, like, you know, I did 2015 Top 8, and I was all ecstatic and happy and shit, and I wanted to go shake his hand and tell him thanks for the opportunity. And he was like, yeah, whatever. That's right. Damn, dude, man, fuck you too, then. So after that, I just kind of... Had a totally different air about me after 2016 and then, or 2015, and then 2016 kind of screwed me over. So 2017, I feel like what's gonna happen is they're gonna hit me up and then I'm gonna turn it down because I'm not fulfilling my fucking demands, and then they're gonna have Smash 4 like as the last game.
Oh yeah.
Damn.
Could you imagine? Like, holy shit.
Fucking Mr. Wizard and goddamn Chris Sage is going to be looking at me from across the ballroom like, yeah, you didn't want to turn us down now, huh, nigga? Like,
all right, Marty, I'm not going to answer that question. Come on. You know that's dumb. Jay says, with legacy dudes like Wong and Momochi? I don't know. Leaving EG, is it just a matter of time for PPMD to get the boot? Maybe. I don't know,
man. I mean, he managed to stay on there for a whole year without going to anything. Like, what a god. Most people would have got dropped within like the third month, but they believe in PP. Yeah. Bet money though, if he doesn't top 8 the Genesis or whatever he goes to, they're probably gonna be like, all right, man.
Yeah.
So, you know, we helped you out, but
I need PP to come back.
Yeah. Well, he just got re-signed, so like he's still on the team for at least however long the contract is. So he's firmly there. He's snug. Which is crazy because he doesn't go to anything. But good, glad they're sticking with him. Soda says, "What were your favorite and least favorite Smash moments in 2016?" I would normally that's dope this, but like it's the end of 2016, so we got to do something. Favorite and least favorite. Favorite is probably the set where Ally beat Zero at Smash and Splash 2 because I feel like that was the first time Zero like. Blew up, like, in terms of, you know, not... That was the first time we saw that Zero was, like, actually mortal, you know? It wasn't the first time he lost, but, like, he got dominated that set. So, probably that. In terms of least favorite moments, probably the Hyuga thing. That was bad. it was a bad look for everybody involved.
Yeah,
so.
It was pretty bad.
I
think I'd probably just go with that, those answers. The Hyuga thing was pretty bad. It's even worse, though, because, like, I literally saw him, like, an hour before. I guess I never saw him again, and then I went the next day to that. And,
yeah.
And Hugo was definitely fucked up, but I didn't get that vibe from him at all that he was about to be out here extra wild. But,
yeah.
Yeah. Oh, well.
Yeah. Do you have anything?
I agree with you, guys.
Got it. Okay.
All right.
Yeah. Spottle says, do you feel like Mario's don't really optimize their options / combos? I don't know. Maybe.
I mean, have you seen Zen you play? He optimizes everything. Anti and Ally are just really smart players, so I mean, they do what they need to do to get the job done. I don't know how much further Mario could really get pushed, to be honest with you.
Yeah.
It's pretty bad, you know, butter with a lot of things he does.
Everyone keeps bringing up Smash City LA, and like, you know what's so funny about Smash City LA is that like when it was first announced and D1 was first told me about it, I was like, damn, I kind of want to go. And then like within like 10 seconds of turning that stream, I was like, I'm so glad I didn't fucking go.
It was a rough
one. Ooh, hold on. I just got something from Keith. Ooh, Keith the Human just hit me up with something. Let me just say, guess on Blazone might be a thing. Thank you, Keith. All right, I'll look into this. All right, Chase said Gimmer took God's Laugh Co. down with him. I don't know what you mean. I love God's Laugh Co., but I don't know what this is in reference to.
I haven't seen that guy in forever.
He actually went to my school. He's cool as shit.
Oh, yeah, no, he's cool as fuck. I just haven't seen him in forever.
Yeah, he's a PM player. Tenixium, what's everyone's favorite Oreo cookie flavor? The normal one. That's the only good one. Unless the golden ones. Those are
yeah, I was going to say the golden one. Yeah, that's me.
Yeah. Silver G says, do you think commentators should interact with the Twitch chat more during and between games? No, absolutely not. No. Don't look at the chat ever. Absolutely not.
That's just not fun because all you guys, like, the people who talk the most are the people who are just talking shit. So,
yeah.
We like to interact with Twitter. That's where we go. Yes. We go, Twitter, you know, we'll read Twitter between matches. We even tell you to do that. We're like, hey, man, if you got anything you want to say or input or whatever, or like, we'll be in the middle of a match, and be like, I don't actually know when that's supposed to kill, blah, blah, blah. So, yo, any of you fucking Pac-Man mains, let me know, and then we'll just read that out later. So, yep. That's dope. Never the fucking Twitch chat.
We'll sometimes read the Twitch chat just to get a gauge on, like, how people think things are going. Like, we'll do that, but, like, we never talk about it. We will never let you know, because, like, there's nothing to be gained.
If you have to rely on the Twitch chat to keep commentary going, you're probably not a very good commentator.
Yep. Real shit, the only time I actually read Twitch chat is when we're not on, so I can be like...
Damn.
That's my shit. You show up in the Twitch chat, like, at like a fool's match. Why are you not commentating? Like, I can't commentate everything, man.
Darius, I'm not reading that question for EE. That doesn't... I don't... Alright, I'll read it. Maybe EE knows what... Maybe this is an inside joke. EE, did you know that George Washington doesn't have a middle name, so it's just George Washington, not George W. Washington?
Yeah, when I was on commentary for the crew battle, I said George W. Washington would not stand for this.
Oh.
I meant to say George Washington, but somehow that W just snuck in there. But yes, I'm privy to that knowledge, and I appreciate you inquiring about it. You know,
it will not happen again.
There's a lot going on in that crew battle that just made me kind of lose sight of everything.
Yeah.
My bad.
All right, let's see. Alex B says, what's the best way to grow as a commentator? Do it a lot. That's it.
Do it, but also realize that, you know, if it's not in your personality, it's not going to work. I mean, like if you can't... What happens is, there's always people I feel like there's some people that are hopeless. And like, whenever someone is afraid to talk to me in a one-on-one because I'm, like, me, then I don't believe that they can talk to 5,000 people. 50K people if the tournament gets that fucking huge. So they come up, and they're stuttering, they're asking questions like, how do I get better at commentary? And then I have to give them this bullshit answer. Oh, man, you just gotta try, you gotta practice, whatever. But, like, just the way that you came off of me at the beginning is gonna make me feel like, you can't do this shit. Like,
yeah,
it's just not you. It's just, you're not a person who can take that, take that pressure of being judged at all times, and especially being in front of a camera if you can't even talk to one person. So that's just me, though. And I could be wrong, but that's just how I see it.
Yeah, I got you. All right. Where did my window go? Come on, there it is. Okay. A1 says Day 1. How do you feel about announcers like Nightwing at Big House 6 where they talk about sets that happen off stream? Cool idea, needs to be implemented, I think, in a better way. I think it took away from, like, I didn't like the format at Big House 6. I wasn't watching the stream, so I don't know what it was like, but, like, I feel like it could have been done in a better way.
You talking about the 4 interviews?
I think it just needs to be done a little better.
I love the idea behind that. Actually, I know TK is like probably gonna be doing, it's gonna be doing an MCing at Genesis 4. I've been talking to some people about doing some floor interviews myself for Smash 4. So if I do it, I think it'll be pretty hype.
I don't know what the hell I'm doing anymore, man. I actually have to hit them up.
Let me just
write Bear now, man. Like, Jesus fuck.
Yeah, I need to figure
the last thing I sent Bear was, can me and Cody do Top 16?
Okay.
He was just like, alright, well, I'm running it by the guys. So I was like, let TK and D1 do Top 8. Let me and Cody do Top 16. That'd be pretty fucking dope.
That'd be awesome. Yeah, I would love that. Honest.
Yeah.
Well, we need some Florida. I mean, we need some Cali representation. D1 got them. Get out.
No. I think the last thing I got talked about was they switched me and Gunblade for something because Gunblade had no single slot, so I gave him one of mine. So I'm doing doubles with Vicky at one point, I think. So.
All right, come on, man. Stop hating. I don't like the way you said that.
What?
Like the way you said that.
No, I didn't say anything wrong. I said
I'm doing doubles with Vicky.
That wasn't how I said it. I just I went down. I'm doing doubles with Vicky. There's nothing wrong with that.
That's not how you said it.
I said I just went. My cadence was going down. Like, I'm going to go to the store. I'm doing doubles with Vicky. There's nothing wrong with that. I didn't mean it like that. Vicky's great. No problem. There's no problem here. What? I didn't do anything.
I'm tweeting at Vicky right now with this fucking clip.
All right, do it. Do it. Vicky's a wonderful lady. All right.
Yeah, she's fine, too.
I didn't say all that. Come on.
I didn't say anything.
Come on.
Nigga, I did.
I'm married.
Yeah, I'm 26, 2017 until you breathe and settle down, so I can't even look at her. I never even look in her direction. We can never commentate. I just be looking at her the whole time. She'd be like trying to get a plate over. I'm like,
I'm just saying, man. DJ Jack is like 6'9", so you know, watch yourself. So
I just complimented her.
You gonna
swing on me for saying your girl looks good? I mean, what the heck? What are you gonna do if I say she's ugly? Like, that's the real kicker right there.
All right, Austin says thoughts on locals growing lately. Xeno and NYC had 100+. And MSM in Cali today has 200+. Signs of a great start to 2017. That's awesome. That's great. Certainly hope so.
Yeah, for sure.
I know Xanadu has been going through, like, it fluctuates. Like, summer's really big. Winter, especially around finals time, shuts down a little bit more. But that's awesome to hear. I mean, Xanadu was breaking that, like, pretty regularly. I think it's kind of on the downswing, but it's awesome to see that other locals are blowing up.
I just saw a tweet right now that says MSM is nearly at 200 entrants.
Let's go, MSM.
Good shit.
Definitely will be watching that.
That's awesome. And Harlan, final question of the night. Final question. And I don't know if it's going to be an especially long one, but says, how will Smash 4 be impacted at events if it utilizes the Nintendo Switch, assuming it's a release title? Depends on how many changes there are.
Depends on how many people are playing steal a Switch, because that system seems very hard to maintain.
Yeah.
Just slide it out. Like, you just, like, come, leave your house with your two Switch pieces, right? And then, like, so leave your Switch at home, but bring the remote, and then just do, like, a flyby. that should happen. I as much as I would want to stop it, I think I would just be bust out laughing. Just like in the middle of a set, some guy just comes through.
That'd be pretty good. I didn't even think of that. That's true.
Damn. And someone would definitely be like, I still get to finish my set though, right?
Yeah. Alright, so anyway, that's going to do it. Thank you guys for watching Blast Zone. We do this every 2 weeks, unless we can't. On twitch.tv/ConyZZ. Go ahead and hit this channel with a follow if you want to see it. I also play other games, mostly PC games, but you can go ahead and follow this. And if you don't want to watch it, that's fine. Just come through for the Blast Zone. We tweet about it. We'll tweet about it. Just go ahead and watch that. Anyway, we will be seeing you guys after Genesis. I don't know. We can't do a show in 2 weeks because my flight gets back at like 12 a.m. on Tuesday. So we'll figure something out. You guys will see us in a few weeks.
We literally won't be able to do a show for the rest of this year, month. Because
this year?
Because me and E are going to PAX South, and we come back on Monday, too. So.
Might be a Wednesday show coming up at some point. We'll figure it out, but you'll just follow the stream and you'll see it. You can sub to any of us three. If you're going to sub to anybody, sub to these guys first, because they play mostly Smash, and because they are content creators full-time. And they stream a lot more, and they're awesome. So they also have better emotes, I think. My emotes are kind of. I need a.
I think all of our emotes are really cool.
I think there's always an emo that can go. But you know what? You ever had that emo that you hate but everyone else loves?
Yes. Oh yes. Oh yes.
You're like, yeah, I'm gonna get rid of this emo, but that's my favorite emo. Like everything emo's your favorite emo. Like that's crazy.
So. I still have fucking Terry Hinz. Because people love fucking Terry Hinz. Like, he doesn't even do anything. Like, oh my god. Anyway,
Terry is.
Yeah, he's. Don't worry about it. He's that dude that sits on the floor. There he is. He's showing up in the chat now. Anyway, thank you guys for watching. Do you guys want to do any kind of plug? Let them know where you're going to be, what you're going to be doing?
Yeah, I might end up streaming later tonight. I'm not really sure. Make sure you follow me at TK Breezy. And also, I feel like I talked a lot today, but I just had a lot of shit to get off my chest, so. If I did talk a lot, man, my bad. I'm not trying to omni this shit. But,
the return.
Lay it on me.
Lay it on me. So. But yeah. You know, follow me on Twitter, Twitch. But make sure you definitely follow me on Twitch because I feel like a lot of people who follow me on Twitter don't actually have that alert up where it says I'm streaming. But like, I also don't have a really good schedule. Like, I just kind of stream when I'm up and. As of late, I've been waking up at 10, so I've been streaming at 2, but usually I stream at, like, 10. So, yeah, just follow me on Twitter. Thanks.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, you know, follow me on my newly verified Twitter account, at TheFenomenalE. Also follow me on Twitch, just passed 20,000 followers, so keep it going. And I'm interviewing Void tomorrow for all you Void fans out there. 5 p.m. EST, come through. It's gonna be dope. That's about it, man. Thanks for all the support you guys have given us. It's much appreciated.
Yeah, thank you guys for watching the show throughout the year. Like, Bloodstone has been going on for a pretty long time now, and we always have a pretty steady level of viewership. So thank you guys for watching. These are actually being uploaded to YouTube now. I'll go ahead and give you guys the thing to let you know.
Who's YouTube?
I think it's the archive YouTube that we have. Voodoo put it together. So.
All right.
I know they're not going on your YouTube. I didn't think you were doing anything with your YouTube. The whole point we were putting on your YouTube was because you were going to be putting out more content.
But I am putting out content because you haven't watched my last two Honest Conversations.
Oh, are you doing that? I thought that was just on Twitch. I watched the VOD and I got an email about the VOD. I was watching it and but I didn't think you were putting it on YouTube. That's all.
I'm.
No, I'll talk to Voodoo. We'll put
I gotta
talk to Voodoo and Albub. They're the ones doing it. They're doing awesome.
Put it in your channel. It's fine. It's fine. I don't care.
Okay.
What I was actually going to ask for like a while ago was to switch the last one over to my channel, but then I realized there's all the shit that you got to set up, and I don't think my PC can handle it, so probably not. Yeah, because like that's a moving screen, which means it's most likely a video, and my OBS is not doing a really good job with videos, so
yeah, it would blow up.
Doesn't even fucking matter. I already have too many talk shows as is.
just talk radio.
Talk shows right now. Yeah.
Just Howard Stern. Yeah. Alright, thank you guys for watching. Blast Zone is over. We'll see you guys in a few weeks after Genesis 4. Don't know when. Follow the channel. Follow everybody else. We're going out. So we'll see you guys next time. Goodbye.
Take care, everybody.
Goodbye. It's just me. Look at that face. Isn't that funny? Goodbye.
Wow, what an absolutely incredible stream from me, the Honorable Grand King Kony ZZ. One that will go down in the history books as the best Twitch broadcast of all time. We laughed, cried, and maybe even learned a little something along the way. What was your favorite part of the stream? That was my favorite part too. Please don't cry, though our adventures are coming to an end. Let us always remember the good times. I say to you, my fellow kings, dry your tears. The stream may be over, but its cherished memory will live forever on in our hearts. Until next time, my name is Kony ZZ, and thank you for watching my stream. Go the fuck to sleep.